Should probably pull up YouTube or something.
Okay, so I'm streaming.
Okay. Now let's see.
No drop frames so far. And it's using 15.8% of the GPU.
Oh, here we go. Okay. So I can see you streaming right now. So I'm gonna go in to edit the video.
Cool.
And then I'm going to make it unlisted.
Cool.
Cool. So it is now unlisted. So you're still live streaming. Mm-hmm. All right. So let's change the thumbnail and the title. So thumbnail. There we go. And then we'll make the title of this.
Oh my god. I haven't looked at this at the Discord in a couple days. They put a mask over Batman's face.
This is Batman Arkham Asylum.
Arkham Knight, not Arkham Asylum.
Okay. Arkham Knight is in with a K.
Yeah.
Let's see. So, playing Batman Arkham Knight to avoid Corona.
Yeah, whatever you want to do.
What do you think?
Crime fighting Corona. No.
To fight Corona. Okay, and then description. Playing. And then Arkham Knight. Join us in chat for a chill stream.
How am I going to be able to see the chat?
So that's one of the nice things about Streamlabs is that you can see that in real time.
I could just have it on my phone.
Yeah, we're going to have to just have to open it up separately on YouTube or I could respond to the chat.
I can just look at my phone. Have it right next to the microphone.
That'll work. Let's go to tags. Saved. Alright, so now I'm gonna go to the stream and see how it sounds.
Alright. To be fair, there isn't much music in the menu. But you should be able to hear something. I'm gonna put my headphones on.
Alright, so I'm gonna mute you real quick.
Go ahead.
Alright, so it sounds fine. That I would recommend though turning down the game volume a bit.
Alright, 1 second.
So in OBS, what you want to do is just under audio mixer, scroll down to
Roxio Keck.
Roxio, yeah, and then just, yeah, turn that down to like, yeah, that's good.
Alright, you want to check to see how it sounds?
Yep, okay, so I'll mute you on dip real quick. I'd turn it down a little more.
Alright. One second. Alright, let's try negative 3. How's that? Better?
Sounds fine. Yeah, it sounds better.
Cool.
Alright, so that looks good. Gonna make sure I mute the stream so I don't hear different versions of us.
Yeah, so you don't go insane, you mean?
Yeah, exactly. Okay, so that sounds good. It's streaming right now. It seems to be streaming well. Like, there's no lag to my knowledge. So that's good. That means we can do more of these in the future. So let's do... Let's see. I won't worry about putting in a playlist yet. Okay, so everything is set up, so we can make this public if you want. Or we can, I'm gonna make some tea so I don't
pass out. Go for it.
And then, we can come back. We could enable the stream right now if you want, and like let people come in, and then
yeah.
We can start.
Go ahead.
I'm just gonna make some tea, and then I'll make this stream public.
I want to share it in the Discord, so yeah. I'm gonna do that right now.
Yeah.
Can I do that already, even though it's unlisted?
You can, but why don't we start... Let's not share the stream until we're both ready.
Alright, cool.
Alright, so I'm gonna just go and make some tea. BRB.
Okay. Oh, 100%. I'm gonna do one of these and not the fucking... A panty raid. Hey, Pop!
Yeah?
I want to be recording, so don't barge in, alright? Okay. Yeah, I'm probably gonna go for that. I might just get the season fucking pass. How much is the season pass?
Hello.
Hello. I'm just looking at a few things I might want to get. What does it include? Add-on to this game. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna buy this. I'm looking at, like, 'cause there's certain things I still wanna buy. I don't know if they have an all-over season pass, so I can just get everything at once, or if I had to buy some of this separately. No, I'm very tempted to get panties, Robin.
You should.
I should. Robin doesn't really come in too much until later, so I'll save it, but I want to get that, and I want to get my favorite Robin suit, and then I have most of this already that I care about. I also have the Nolan Batman skin, but I'm not going to use it. I'm just looking to see if there's, like, a season pass besides this. This is a season pass for the extra side missions that are really good. Okay, overview, works with, included in, oh, this is the full-on season pass for $17, and this is $9, so I'm probably not going to do that. All right.
Oh my gosh, there's, Yusuf is already in the chat.
Is he actually? Oh, nice. So you did make it public.
No, it's unlisted. Just it went... It goes up public immediately when you start, but I switched it to unlisted.
So Yusuf was just in that bitch. Yusuf, I wasn't able to look at chat because I was
He probably clicked on like a notification or something.
Yusuf, are you still here? He has channel notifications. Good stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm doing Arkham Knight today. Yusuf, actually, you can help us test the chat. You can return as the third point.
Yeah. Yeah, the chat's working right now. Yeah, I can set it to public right now.
Do it.
If you're ready.
Do it. Okay. It doesn't change the link or anything, right? Because I'm about to link it in fan create.
No, it doesn't. I'm gonna make it public. save. Okay, we should be all set.
All right, sweet. So I'm good to start?
Yeah, you're good to start. Well, we can wait a little bit to let people roll in.
Yeah, I'm down. Yusuf, how's your day going?
I am 0.3. Yusuf is returning to the triple point.
Yeah, Yusuf never left the triple point.
Dude, how'd you know?
Yusuf, are you excited for me to kick some ass as Batman or whatever I'll be doing? Yeah.
Oh, nice. Is the DLC good?
What do you mean? Oh, he's talking. You're talking to Yusuf. I was away from that for a second.
Oh no, yeah. Yusuf said in the chat he's finishing the new Persona 5 DLC. There's cool. A new one came out.
I'm very tempted to buy the DLC that I want to buy on my laptop, so I don't show any credit card information and just have it immediately. But I mean, it's not really gonna matter.
I mean, go with whatever you want. Your choice.
Let me look, because I mean, we're waiting for people, right? Let me know, because I'm not gonna keep it like a perfect eye. Let me know when I'm gonna keep the brightness relatively high. Let me know when we've got a good amount of people so I can start it.
We got 5 people watching right now. I mean, that's pretty good.
You want to start it now then?
Yeah, you can. I feel like the 5 people though is also includes both me and you.
Yeah, so really there's 2 people and Yusuf.
Yeah, so I mean, hey, welcome everybody to the live stream. Let's see, Yusuf says, yeah. Royal is basically the definitive edition of Royal, totally completes the game. Oh, okay, cool. I never got into Persona, even though Tyler has been telling me to play Persona for like 2 freaking years.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I mean, I'm definitely more of a Fire Emblem fan.
You want to see something disgusting, Noel?
What?
Look at the Arkham Robin. He looks like one of the he looks like one of the Ninja Turtles from the Michael Bay movies. With his bald ass head. Oof. But I'm gonna have it set to this one with the floofy hair.
Yeah, I'm not a big fan of the bald head.
Yeah, no, I hated it when it came out.
It kind of reminds me of your haircut, like.
Oh, we're not talking about that. What was I gonna say? Yeah, I didn't like it when they did it in Arkham City, but at least then he had.
Huh? What is that? Is that a Harley Quinn outfit down below, or is that Cap? Or is that
This one?
Catwoman, yeah.
This is the 90s Catwoman one.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
Whoa. But yeah, I'm not gonna have that on. I'm just setting up this stuff. I'm gonna keep the suit default for Batman for now, but I'm probably gonna switch to the 1970s suit later, because I love that suit.
On Discord, make sure you have OBS popped up, because I can only see it through the...
Oh, okay. Good to know. Cool. OBS is only a second or two off. Alright, so I'm gonna start it.
Cool, go for it. Yusuf says, it's definitely a game you can play without knowledge of past games. High key would recommend. Yeah, I do know that it's easy to jump into. I don't know. I'm not a crazy fan of the gameplay and like the slice of life stuff that takes up a lot of the game, but I don't know. I might consider. I have so many other games that are eating up my time that I kind of want to play. I know Persona is a hell of a long game. I've got you under my skin.
I'd sacrifice anything come what might for the sake of. All right, I'm back. Sorry.
So, Tom, why don't you, what's your favorite part about this game? Why don't you tell the viewers?
My favorite part is the Batmobile. That's a lie. My favorite part is Joker being cremated. But, while I'm talking, I'm just gonna leave him there. No, overall, what I love most about this game is what I love about all of them. It's just that really solid gameplay and stealth, and the story is pretty good. I'd say The one that came before this, which is City, we don't talk about Origins, is the best, but this one's still good. No, for context, in the last game, canonically, Joker died. And it's waiting for me to press the button to cremate him.
Gotcha. Is that the game where Joker turns into Hulk Joker?
He turns into Hulk Joker in the first one, and because he did that, he gave himself a disease. And by the end of two, he then dies. And now that he's dead, this is about a year after.
This is how it happened.
Yeah, the Hulk Joker is so weird looking.
This is how the Batman died.
Yeah, Yusef, sing for me.
Nine months ago, Joker was cremated. I pressed the button.
How old is this game?
2015. And it holds up.
And then we waited.
I definitely remember you playing it when it came out.
Oh yeah, I played the hell out of this game.
But it didn't come.
Is this the one that has all the
deep down
the Riddler missions?
The Riddler trophies? That's actually every game.
I thought there was one that had that were more difficult than the other one.
Arkham City has the most difficult ones, I think. But I don't remember because I don't think I did all of them for Arkham Knight, which
I'm just trying to remember. I don't remember which Arkham game the completionist did, but I remember watching his video, and it was, like, way too much to complete.
Yeah, that's probably... I think this one has more of them, but City was harder. I gotta turn this to inverted. But,
You should explain to the fellow streamers who haven't watched our Halo videos why you play on inverted.
Oh, so when I was 3 years old, little tyke, my first video game that I ever played was Halo 1, and my brother, to beat me in a 1v1, he changed my controls to inverted, so I would have a hard time looking around, because he wanted an even greater advantage over a child.
I know, so what a nice brother.
Yeah. I gotta just plug in my phone really quick, sorry. But I'll keep this going.
Thanks.
No problem. I'm currently playing as a cop.
Oh, yeah.
Thanks,
honey.
Yeah.
Nice.
So, what'll it be?
Good thing there's no black people in here.
No, why are you saying that?
Salad with no dressing.
No, you know what?
Are there none? With a side of there's one right there.
well.
Whatever you say, officer.
We know how this ends.
Oh, and if you want some more coffee...
This room is actually filled with Easter eggs. I'm not going to go crazy, but you can see this guy getting bullied with the Batman mask. This takes place on Halloween.
Gotcha, that makes sense. I mean, the jack-o'-lantern definitely is a dead giveaway. Officer, who's this chump?
There's a guy smoking over there in the corner booth. Wait here. I'll have a word.
Yeah, there's tons of Easter eggs and stuff that are gonna lead to the later on in the game, but we're gonna skip most of that.
Yep.
Dom, steal the jack-o'-lantern.
I should talk to that customer who's smoking before.
Oh, damn.
Dom, why don't you steal the jack-o'-lantern?
I can't, but I can look at all these people. Hello.
Yeah, he's like, yo, nothing to see here, officer.
I've been waiting for my eggs since this morning. I still haven't gotten my fucking eggs. All they gave me was dirty dishes. Yes, that's how that Asian sounds.
When you mention eggs, and if you think of the Game Grumps Oni plays, video where they're like,
I don't know if I
eggs for Bart.
Eggs for Bart.
Eggs.
It's like, look at that simp over there. He got his eggs.
Eggs. I like my eggs. I like my women scrambled. Whoa there.
What?
Yusuf in the chat.
What
I
did
like
you...
my eggs. Like I like my women.
Nice. Alright, I'm gonna go mess with this dude over here. Yes, I'm gonna check him out. Damn.
One guy has 75,000.
Excuse me, sir.
I mean, I guess
you can't smoke in here.
I guess scrambled is better than poached or hard boiled. Yo, that guy's got a nasty jewel.
I forgot how cool this scene is.
Is that supposed to be
He's a scarecrow henchman. I just got hit with fear toxin, and people are going wild. Now, I can shoot these people, even though they're civilians.
Or just, that sounds like the cop thing to do. You're getting bodied.
Yeah.
Suspected corona attack.
This demonstration used.
Dude, I didn't realize that Scarecrow is the cause of the epidemic.
Yeah, actually. They're all evacuating.
Gotham, this is your only warning.
I like Scarecrow in the 2000
the Nolan movies. Yeah, he's pretty cool.
I didn't like him in the third one though, because he's kind of just a joke.
Yeah, I really liked him in the first one because the boss battles for him were basically you had to hide from a giant scarecrow and shine it the bat signal at him, and it was like this huge platforming like challenge. In this game, he's a lot more just like the villain at the end rather than like a boss fight.
There were 6.3
gotcha.
Million
yeah
people
but
turn into Hulk Scarecrow?
No.
Not so many.
This was their like in-story explanation of why the city isn't populated by citizens, because they all evacuated.
Interesting.
The only people left on the streets are the sort that enjoy the chaos.
Gotham.
I really hope someone isn't mowing my lawn as I'm trying to stream right now. Can you hear that?
I can't hear that.
Oh no, no.
Why does that guy's arm look all messed up?
That's, Two-Face.
Why does his arm have to be bruised?
Cause he was burned. Half his body was burned. And that's his thing, is like the, that's his look. He's honestly not even really in the game much.
I understand, like, his face, but, like, do they really need to accentuate, like, a burned arm?
Yeah.
Like, it's not, like...
Gotham's relying on one man.
He's not called, like, half-burn victim or whatever. Like, it has face in the name for a reason.
Yeah, Yusuf, that's a very good point. New York probably should have evacuated.
Abigail in the chat. I'm so late to this. Nah, we just started.
Yeah, we're just getting moist in this rain here.
Exactly, because dry is not an option.
Dude, I have not played this probably since like 2016. This is so nice. Alright. I'm flying.
See, Gotham may have a better pandemic response, but are they testing? I don't think so. Do you think Wayne Enterprise would give out free corona tests, or do you think they'd be like, no?
Of course they would. He's a philanthropist. He likes to help people.
What if? Dude, I can't wait for Mr. Beast to surpass PewDiePie and then just buy New York City and become real life Batman. Have you ever watched Mr. Beast videos?
Mr. Beast for the win? I've seen him. He's always on trending. Yeah, I've seen him.
Yeah. Dude, that guy just every video he uploads is just instantly number one on trending.
Last bus crossed the city.
I just can't wait for one to be like, "What's up, guys? We just bought a city and I'm going to become real life Batman."
And give out $100,000 to every person I maim.
It's the only lead we
We've had all night. It's just, we bought this real city and we paid all the residents $1 million to get out of town for the week.
If you find it, tell your men not to engage. I'll deal with it.
Do you really think Scarecrow's crazy enough to detonate a chemical weapon in Gotham?
I won't let that happen, Jim.
I fucked your daughter, Jim.
It's going to be a long night.
Let's see, Abigail says, I've been struggling to find a name for this character. I'm guessing that's the character that you were drawing the time we were streaming. Tom, think of a name for a character.
Hey, Batman.
Every damn time.
Glip.
Glip?
Glip.
Glip.
Glip Trudgington.
I need to look.
All right, there you go. That's the name.
Already working on it. How's my dad doing?
He's holding up.
Somehow he always does.
Dude, I love when.
Okay, I'm sending through this one person.
I love when YouTubers just put in like just the most outrageous names whenever you get to name.
Yeah, I wish I could name Batman.
What would you name Batman in this game if you had the option?
Gloose Blaine.
Our bad Adabra 27 says, hi guys, hello.
What up? Thank you for joining in the stream.
We got Voldemort in here.
No, you're not supposed to say his name.
You're right, then YouTube will demonetize us.
Yeah.
I found it really funny that a lot of YouTubers have basically made this joke. Look, we're like,
oh,
YouTube demonetizes everyone if they say Corona. Like, we're not making money off of this. I'm questioning this.
No! I found Jesus Christ!
You have?
Alfred,
oh my God.
I discovered a mutilated body. I'm going to try and
I hung him up like Jesus Christ.
I hung him up like Jesus Christ for all the monkeys to see. Yeah, this has to do with a side mission. I'm not going to do it right now. I would like to do the side missions, though, because most of them are pretty good and don't involve the Batmobile.
Why do you hate about the Batmobile so much?
It's overused. I mean, it's cool, but like overall, it gets kind of tedious when that's like the solution to everything.
Yeah, I know.
I'm gonna break this dude's leg.
I find it very interesting when video game developers get carried away with putting in like vehicle missions. Because there are definitely a handful of video games that are like, oh, we have vehicles? Yes. Let's just put in as many of these as possible. Like an example, the original Crash Bandicoots had more vehicle stuff, like the further and further they got into the series.
Yeah.
To the point where you could tell they just wanted to make a racing game, so that's what they ended up doing. Just it's TTR.
I'ma help this cop. Oh wait.
Oh. I still haven't played CTR. Tyler was like, oh, let's play CTR on the Switch. And I was like, I don't know if I want to buy that.
We have a problem. Before I continue, Abigail is questioning the name Glip, so we have to come up with something else. What does this statue have? What's this guy's name tag? Hold up. Excuse me, sir. Sir. Oh, wait, it says it. Officer Cavern. Cavern with a K. How about Cavern?
You're safe.
I
thought they were gonna it's Officer Cavern. Jules
Cavern. City's overrun. We don't stand a chance.
Stay here. Remember I'll that send scene someone in, to pick you up.
What are you doing?
Back to the Future 3.
Evening the odds.
No, I don't.
Remember Back to the Future 3 when Doc is talking to the lady? Hardware. And she's like, my favorite author is Jules Verne. And then Doc's like, you've read Jules Verne too.
Abigail has accepted the name Cavern.
Cavern will be.
And this game has officially lost one star.
I'll keep to it. That will be his last name.
I don't hate that the Batmobile's in the game because people asked for it since the first one. I just hate that they made it like
that military vehicle.
Instead of, I would have preferred it to just be a car instead of a tank that I had to use all the time.
Yeah, I get that. Yo, where's the 1980s Batmobile?
I can't see. Here's the thing, I can't use it until I finish the game, because it doesn't have a tank mode. I have not driven this thing in so long, so this is gonna be a mess.
Doesn't it kind of drive like
GTA?
Yeah, like in GTA where there's like a slowdown.
Yeah. It drives pretty. I can also hit people and it'll shock them instead of killing them.
But Tom, that's not what the Batman does.
Dude, I could just. Oh god. Oh jeez.
Don't worry, Jim. He's mine.
Dude, you're gonna take out the structures of those buildings.
Yeah. Ooh. Okay. That's gonna take some practice.
Tom, what would you do if a slow-mo Batmobile tank just like crashed through the side of your house?
That's a really tough question for me, Noel. I'd either be happy or upset because it crashed into my house.
I mean, that's fair. What if after crashing, he just straight up leaves?
I'd hope that the Wayne Foundation would pay for it.
I mean, maybe.
Where is he?
But then that would be giving away who's Batman. You, Batman.
Talk. Or I'll crush every bone in your body.
Okay. He's working out of a penthouse.
No, he's taking
the fucking Chinese. Batman's worst enemy.
I'll break the other one.
The Chinese.
Yeah.
That's
how they inject Corona.
Dude, that's the vaccine.
I would hope not. I mean, and if that's the case, then Scarecrow's doing a good thing because he's threatening to pump it throughout the city.
Scarecrow is the World Health Organization. Batman is our president.
Batman's Trump? I mean, he is a billionaire. Is Trump a billionaire? He's a millionaire, isn't he?
No, yeah, he's not a billionaire. He wishes, dude, if he wishes he was a billionaire.
Yeah. I'm going to pay him a visit. You could just see the meat in Batman's eyes clearly there. This is going to take me some time to remember how to drive this, but I'll get the hang of it. Power slide is X. Huh?
Batman remote controlling his Batmobile is like every...
this is the place.
Like model car makers.
Yeah, dude, it's awesome.
Well, rip that car.
Well, that dude was chasing the cop, man.
Oh, okay. I thought it was a normal person.
No, there's only cops in these jabronis and their cars chasing cops and abusing them.
Okay.
Yeah, I can actually launch myself. Oh, Jesus, that camera angle. I can launch. Did you see that car run into that guy?
Oh my god.
I can actually launch myself into the air with the Batmobile after an upgrade. That's pretty cool. I just gotta figure out. Alright. Okay, so brake is X. That's gross. Okay. Get me out of this fucking car. I'll get used to it, but...
That is very gross.
I'm much more familiar with, like, gliding.
Why isn't, like, X accelerate and B brake?
I know. Well, the right trigger's accelerate. It won't. You must be standing. Oh, wait. Hold up. Oh, Jesus. How do I use detective? It's, okay. So they changed that from the other games. I forgot about that. Oh. Someone eating bats. You're right, Yusef. I am the beginning of Corona.
Yeah, that's why.
I'm gonna take out the guy with the gun.
Yusef, have you noticed the stream thumbnail? Yeah, well, I guess he figured he should look the part. You should take a look at it. It's beautiful. I can't stand
surprise. Dude, I am so rusty. This is terrible. All good though. I'll get the hang of it. I haven't been hit yet, so that's always good.
Yeah, that's good.
What isn't good is this fucking lawnmower.
Yeah, is that your... Oh no, I just saw it. Yeah, that was all my... I just like making the meme thumbnails for the streams. Like, it's great.
Ooh. These camera angles. And I gotta help Poison Ivy.
Well, that makes
you have to help her?
Yeah.
But Poison Ivy's a bad guy.
He got a tip that Scarecrow was going after her.
Were you expecting to find me, Batman?
Oh.
Or that he was with her, either.
Oh, okay.
Take a look at the chamber.
The real question, Nola, is Poison Ivy wearing anything under a... She's not wearing pants, so she's got panties on. Never mind.
And are those made of plant?
Did she kill a plant for underwear, or did she just grow that? Is that just body hair?
That's a great question. Are they just leaves?
Oh, jeez. Yeah, this is the only game that's M for mature, and they definitely took advantage of that. Not that the other games weren't slouches, but this game gets pretty violent.
Yeah, I mean, 100%. Tom, is Poison Ivy your waifu?
No. She probably smells like pheromones.
What are you doing here?
That's the point.
Why did Scarecrow?
Oh, Kevin Conroy.
No, hello.
Yo.
Tell
I've seen
me.
This somewhere before.
And what if I don't want to?
Then I
Poison Ivy's about to be like...
I love that he threatens her by saying he'll burn every plant in Gotham.
What meeting?
Then I'll turn Gotham into Australia.
Penguin,
whoa,
Riddler, even poor Harley. Scarecrow,
dude, I want Poison Ivy just be like, I'm your lifeguard. And I want Batman to be like, this is a bathtub.
Over my dead body.
I believe that was the idea. I told him that I wasn't interested in his pathetic human games. And when I came to, I was locked up in that room.
Gotta say, this is my least
it's
favorite.
It's such a shame that his vile toxic.
Yeah. Just wait.
Nature.
Now it's gonna become a tentacle hentai.
Oh, yeah. Whoa there.
And now we get to play as Poison Ivy the rest of the game.
That's great. That would be, wouldn't that be hilarious if they like just tricked all of the viewers? We're like, it's like title of Batman game. It starts like a normal
you're
Arkham game, but then it's like, nope, psych, you're playing as Poison Ivy the whole time.
Yeah.
What's wrong?
Oh God! And it begins. The fucking tank battles. It's the Libyans!
Dude, that tank is moving hella fast. That's all I have to say.
Don't move.
Are you sure it's
yeah, you're right, Yusuf. That is true.
The pet pussy. Oh yeah, I can call the Batmobile through the items. The controls are like the same for all the games except this one. This is gonna take a little. Oh, jeez. Yeah, so I can also control the Batmobile remotely.
60mm cannon operational.
Whoa, it's slow motion and sparky.
Riot suppressor engaged.
Oh, Jesus.
Dude, it's like.
There we go. Alright, yeah. I at least remember the tank controls more or less.
Probably because you do a whole lot of tank in this game.
No! No. Shh. Alright, where the hell do they want me to go? Do I have to? Oh, there we go. Oh, shit.
I love how this thing pilots, like, physics just doesn't exist.
Nah. Miss me. Dude, what if I just do this whole game without getting hit once?
I mean, I guarantee you're gonna get hit.
Eventually, but I mean, so far I've been doing pretty good. The tank is gonna be annoying once it's like 30 of them at once.
For anyone
I love that he's got like a car seat for people in the Batmobile. Yeah. What were you gonna say?
Oh, for anyone who hasn't seen our Sunshine videos, generally, it's Tom's kryptonite when I tell him don't
There are more on the way.
Activate the Batmobile weapon.
It's time to go to war. It's time. And this game loses yet another star, Noel.
Damn. Do you think riding in this Batmobile is very comfortable in that seat?
In a hearse seat? Maybe. Yeah.
And this is reminding me of there is a you play this game too. Do you remember the PlayStation 2 era Transformers movie game?
Oh dude, that was the best. The first one was awesome because it was open world.
There is a mission that really got me hung up on as a kid, where because you can play as Autobots and Decepticons, it's two different stories. If you chose Autobots, there's a mission where you have to chase down these Decepticons.
Yeah, and they're random Decepticons.
Yeah, but they're driving away. You have to chase them down as Bumblebee in the car. And I remember that one being nearly impossible when I was a little kid, because
the missile barrage is what I have to do.
They start hella far away, and you gotta chase them down. If they get too far away, then it just ends the mission. They're GG, no re.
Yeah. Dude, that game was one of my favorites. I remember my dentist, wait, what do I have to do? I have to charge. Okay, so I have to charge it. Charge the missile barrage. Pressing the X.
I never ended up finishing it because my save data got corrupted.
You didn't finish it?
The PlayStation. I finished the Autobots one.
Oh, that's what I had to do. Okay.
The Decepticon one.
I finished both. The boss battle against Megatron was the hardest thing of my life. It was one of those things where, as a kid, I had no idea
how difficult the level 2 Decepticon boss battles are. I need to power up. Because No.
I can't remember which is harder, Optimus Prime or Megatron, but I remember it was one of those things as a kid where I had to stop and then play the game again when I was better developed mentally, when I was 2 years older. Yeah, to beat it.
Dude, I couldn't get past what's the name of that helicopter Decepticon? Blackout?
Blackout, you're right, yeah.
I couldn't get...
He was a nightmare.
That boss battle, I could never get past.
Megatron was the worst for me, but that was the other one.
Yeah, Megatron wasn't fun either. Although, at least you got to play as Optimus Prime.
Yeah.
Because with the Blackout one, you had to play as Iron... You play as, Ironhide, and he sucks.
Yeah, Ironhide sucks. Jazz was cool because he had, the railgun. And then, Bumblebee was cool, too. I liked Bumblebee when he was in his, Hot Rod 70s, form. But, I remember as a kid, my dentist, he was filling my cavities, and we were talking about video games. And he was, a cool dad type guy. So he went on IGN's website back in 07 and printed me out, the cheat codes to the Transformers game.
Oh my god, but wait, but did they work?
Yeah, they worked. On the Wii.
Oh my god. Frickin'...
Oh, I've been hit. Well...
printed out cheat codes for that video game and they didn't work.
Dude, I bet your parents didn't know to, make sure they were the Wii ones. And then they ended up doing the, Or, did you have a PS2?
Yeah, it was PS2.
Yeah, they probably thought you had it for the Wii and used the Wii cheat codes because they were different.
Oh! I just remember, back then, there were, a crap ton of internet websites that posted cheat codes, and some of them were fake cheat codes.
Yeah, I got the real ones, and they even had, skins for, the 80s looks for the characters that were cel-shaded. I didn't use that much, but that was cool.
Thinking back on it, I wonder what... why do you think the websites would post fake cheat codes? Is it just to get people to go to their site?
I don't know, man. But I mean, I know IGNs were legit.
Sicko was I'm gonna post these fake cheat codes just to psych out all these kids.
It's the original Keck. Oh, sick jump. I can't wait to get the rocket booster. That'll make this a little more bearable.
I like that. I kind of miss that a lot of games don't have cheat codes.
Yeah, I always like it and think it's like really cool when games have cheat codes that are come out now. Like, Red Dead 2 has cheat codes. I didn't use them, but that's still cool.
Does it have big head mode?
I don't know, but I know that this game and Arkham City have big head mode.
The big head mode is so funny.
Yeah. I think Arkham Knight has big head mode, and if it does, we'll set that up later.
Any progress with the fear toxin analysis?
It's gonna take a little while longer.
Now I'm at the police station.
I'll show you what I've got so far.
I honestly think that I'm not gonna use the Batmobile unless I have to for this game.
Yeah, I mean,
it's cool. I like driving around. I just don't like all the tank stuff. That's honestly my one complaint with this game, really. The story isn't as good as the first two, but it's still good. And it's probably because Paul Dini, who wrote like the animated series and stuff, he wrote the first two and then was done with DC by this game.
Why do you even bother?
Interesting.
So Rocksteady got a writer for this game.
There's a war on the streets. We don't have the manpower or the equipment.
Gordon's like, what's that smell? Oh, Ivy.
That's one less thing to worry about.
Smell.
The isolation chamber. Glad you're putting it to good use.
Oh, good. Another cell.
I will say there's one really cool twist about this game that makes it 100 times better. I'm not going to spoil it because it's coming up in like maybe 15, 20 minutes, but it's very cool.
You feel safer now that I'm all locked up.
Reality of the situation is this. We no longer have control of this.
I can only do this until I get a gadget that turns into my right trigger.
You moving on them? Show him the schmooves.
You can't lock me in here like some human. You know these
walls. What's your favorite Harry Potter move?
This one.
This, yeah.
Come on,
bro. Batman's got the schmooves.
This is I'll talk to Gordon.
Screw you, damn bureaucrats. We're on our own.
They're like, the entire city under siege? Eh, we don't need the military.
Yeah, just call them Batman.
Give us a rundown.
Yeah.
Just call them the Bat Tank.
We paid for that Bat Signal, so we wouldn't have to deal with you.
Yeah, their whole budget just goes into hiring the Batman.
We've got their last known coordinates, but they're not going to survive out there on their own for long.
Sir, this is not a Harry Potter movie.
Can I just walk away? No, damn it.
Don't you agree this is actually the third Harry Potter movie that you're playing?
Dude, this is Order of the Phoenix. What do you mean?
No.
This is the director's cut of Order of the Phoenix.
I mean, I would take this over Order of the Phoenix.
Yeah.
Any day.
Look, I know you're busy, but anything you can do to help is going to save lives. Don't worry, Jim.
I love Order of the Phoenix.
I don't know why it has the most annoying characters.
I think it's because I just like Sirius Black a lot.
But Sirius Black is in the fourth one.
That's true, and I also like the fourth one. That one's, you know what? Prisoner of Azkaban is my favorite.
Yeah, Prisoner of Azkaban is like the Sirius Black movie. I mean, like, he dies in Order of the Phoenix, but like...
Yeah, he's hardly in Order of the Phoenix.
Order of the Phoenix, like, the,
Abigail really does not like what she's hearing from you.
Order of the Phoenix is the worst movie.
Mm.
Next to, of course, the Deathly Hallows Part 1.
I like Deathly Hallows Part 1. Oh, hello.
It's nowhere near as good as part two.
We've got
I want to watch one Harry Potter movie in full, and that was the last one. The last one is one of the best ones. It's just so much.
She is definitely noticed me senpai right now.
Oh, yeah. The first.
We have a classic example of a Sibet.
It looks like Izzy's sister, actually.
You know, as long as that symbol's in the sky,
is still the last, the first, the part one of we Deathly Hallows has like been Batman, so freaking slow, and they're like, they get like one Horcrux, and then Batman. The second one's like, well, we only have one movie left, so we're gonna get them all.
You really think you're gonna convince him to stay? One thing I do want to check out before we leave is the cop that we were playing as is in here somewhere. This is where I'm going to end up locking up all the really bad guys. I'm looking for the cop. That's communications room. No. Evidence room. That's a cool place. We'll go there later. Where he at, fam?
This elevator's locked down, Batman. Only way in or out is through the parking garage.
I would love it if Batman just has like a little desk he sits at.
Yeah, he's got a little desk with a bunch of with a bunch of dust on top of it.
Yeah, he's got a paid salary. He just does paperwork.
Yeah.
In the bat suit, of course.
What's Rafferty Squad doing? Well, forget about it. Let's go. I told him to... Oh no, here he is.
The cave swooshing around is so silly in the police department.
He ain't gonna be able to live with himself when he finds out what he did in that diner.
He's gonna lose his badge for sure. Owens is a good cop. Lives for the job.
Yeah, and so over the course of the game, he's gonna be more and more sane as he comes down from the fear toxin. Hey, oh, I love this.
Scarecrow gave you the slip. You broke my wrist for nothing. He's got plans for you, Batman. You and all your friends. Tonight's the night we finally break the bat.
Guy's got weird face. Oof.
That's definitely illegal, but all good. They didn't see anything.
Yeah, they don't do anything to Batman. I think Batman abides by the laws.
I still keep seeing that car coming for us, Batman. I was like a rabbit in the headlights.
He just like opens the door so angrily.
Air support saw turned into some kind of tank. Nice.
Hello, sir. I was just admiring your nice tank.
I was just trying to take your rims.
Sell them on the pier.
This dude is trying his hardest to do a Morgan Freeman impression. Lucius Fox. Oh, yes. Finally. I got the afterburner.
It was good of you to stay behind.
Abigail and Chad are saying that when Sirius and Lupin died are sad. Yeah, they are sad. Harry Potter, Deathly Hallows Part 2 is really sad.
Remnants of Gotham, I have messages for you all. To the vandals who stayed behind to pick and do all pleasure of Gotham.
My favorite Harry Potter movie is Goblet of Fire.
See, that was always my least favorite as a kid. It bore me.
I don't know why, though. It does so many... It changes up the formula from, like, the first three a lot. And it just does a lot of really cool things.
So they don't have the Batcave in this game, which is stupid, but they have Oracle's Clock Tower. You know Oracle's Batgirl when she becomes paralyzed. And they set her up with Tim Drake, which makes me angry.
Identity confirmed.
It's gross.
Why is it making you angry?
Because she's supposed to be Nightwing's age and, like, with him, but she's with Tim Drake... And, like, but she wears the necklace Nightwing gave to her in the comics in this game. It's just, it makes me feel like they didn't really know what they were doing with this character. Just a tad. He's, studying the, this is him looking at Corona.
Do I come in the Batcave and start messing with all
Isn't there
stuff?
You've managed to reduce the comic. Isn't there, like, a comic or, like, a show or something where Oracle, like... regains her leg function.
So when they rebooted the comics in around like 2012 with the New 52, they were like, well, she's not paralyzed anymore, so she could be Batgirl. It's so dumb. And the girl who was Batgirl at the time was pretty much written out. Lawnmower? Being a ginger?
Let me know when you've reached the
But yeah, there's tons of little Easter eggs and stuff in here, but I'm not gonna go crazy with all that.
Dude, that entire conversation you cut out on Discord, but not on the stream.
Really? That's weird. Yeah. My laptop is just having a seizure with all this going on.
Where Crane's working from.
Yeah.
Thank God. What can I do?
Get your men ready. As soon as we've got a location, I'll let you know.
All right.
Tom, is Oracle your waifu?
No. I'd argue I don't have a waifu in this game, Noel. Not gonna lie. You know what? Oracle, when she's Batgirl, is my waifu. But that's a DLC. See, gliding is just so much cooler in this game than driving.
I mean, it definitely looks cooler, for sure. I do find it very interesting when you have these kind of like open world platformy cities.
Yeah. And it's like multi-layered and has a bunch of Easter eggs and secrets.
I find it so funny that like both Batman games and Spider-Man games both have this kind of like mechanic.
Yeah. I'll say that the Arkham games definitely paved the way for the Spider-Man PS4 game. It in a lot of ways is a spiritual successor to this game.
I mean you could arguably consider like the early PS2 Spider-Man
games. That's true. That's a good point.
Cuz like they do a lot of the stuff that the PS4 Spider-Man does, like the Spider-Man 2 PS2 game, where it's like just like this, where it's like all open city and
yeah,
you can just swing anywhere.
But I mean, the combat in those games was a little different.
Oh yeah, well, I mean, it is a PS2 game.
You don't know, do you?
I love Sunset Overdrive.
Sunset Overdrive is a great game. I'm really disappointed that it's never gonna be on Xbox again.
Yeah.
Supposedly they're making a sequel for PS5. We'll see about that.
The generator's damaged. I need to bypass.
I would love it if they put it on PC as well. But
yeah.
If they make another Sunset Overdrive and it's only on PS5, I don't know if it'd be enough to get me to buy the PS5. But it would.
It definitely won't. I already made my decision. I'm not getting a PS5. Not anytime soon. I'm gonna wait for a price to drop.
I am not gonna buy either of the consoles if they're $500.
Yeah, but you have a PC that pretty much runs at that level that they're gonna be, you know.
Oh yeah.
And like any exclusive I'd want to play with you on Oh jeez, I forgot about that. Any exclusive that I'd want to play with you on Xbox is gonna be on it's gonna be on PC.
That's true. I think when they release Infinite, it's gonna be on. They're gonna launch it on Xbox first.
No, it's gonna be PC and Xbox simultaneously, unless they say different.
Because they didn't do that for Halo 5.
No, but like Halo 5 wasn't planned to be on PC. This one from the beginning was planned to be on PC. They definitely. Oh,
yeah,
he's probing. Oh.
I would love for a Sunset Overdrive too.
Yeah, I don't know if Sunset Overdrive will be, but definitely Halo Infinite.
I played so much Sunset Overdrive. I beat both of the DLCs, and I played the multiplayer back when, like, the multiplayer like straight up died like 4 months into the launch of the game because people only really play it for the single player, and you had to beat the story, and then in the story world go into like these little hubs to enter multiplayer. Like, it wasn't super friendly to get into it.
Mm-hmm.
But because I was playing it early enough, I guess a dev was like in the thing, and you get a special achievement just for beating the dev of the game in a multiplayer match. So like, I'm like one of the only people who have that achievement.
That's awesome.
Yeah, it's really cool. Yeah, it makes me so sad because not many people bought the DLC, even though the DLC is hella amazing.
Yeah.
And like the multiplayer maps, you could there are multiplayer maps for the DLC because not a lot of people played the multiplayer and the DLC.
Mm-hmm.
Like, playing the multiplayer maps on the DLC was, like, impossible. You had to, like, play, like, the basic story maps on without the DLC. But like, you got to keep the guns. The DLC guns are sweet. I actually want to replay Sunset Overdrive because I haven't played it since, like, 2014 when it came out.
Oh, there we go. I'd be down to replay it.
Oh yeah, the one thing I'd like, I 100%ed everything in that game, and what I liked about it was that all of the story missions didn't feel like afterthoughts. They were like legit, like the side story. The side story was amazing.
In a lot of ways is how the Arkham games are. The side missions are pretty good. This game probably has the weakest ones. Or you know what, Origins probably does, but it's still pretty good overall. But go ahead, continue, sorry.
Like, the one thing that held me back from doing a Let's Play for the channel is that, like, I wanted to keep my save file, but they only give you one save file per Xbox user.
This is so ridiculous.
So, and if I wanted to replay if I wanted to replay the game for the channel, I had to delete all my save. And I, like, 100%ed it, so, like, I'd have to give up all that work I put into it. Like, I even unlocked all of the, like, customizable clothing.
Remember the kangaroo codpiece?
Oh, yeah, that video is still on the channel.
Yes.
Like, I wouldn't mind replaying everything because it's been so long. It just makes me sad. Like,
yeah. You could always make another profile, make a guest profile, and then you won't need to make another save file.
Yeah, I'm considering that.
Ew! Bald Robin.
What we could. Hey, lets you replay levels. The only problem is that the replay level is alphabetized, and it's not in order of when they appear in the game.
Dude, just make a guest profile on your Xbox, like a profile without Xbox Live, and just use that.
Yeah, I might.
That's what I would do.
Thanks, Aura.
Yeah. That would be a cool,
Ew.
That'd be a cool Let's Play for the channel.
Falcone shipping.
I know I actually recorded the DLC as a Let's Play, but at when that game was out, we had copyright strike up, so I actually had put that to GSF2. So that's still on GSF2, to my knowledge.
I'm surprised that thing is still a thing.
Yeah, well, we keep it around just...
I should have turned notifications off.
We keep it around just so that we can use it for tests, for copyright.
The Batmobile's powering the antenna.
Like, we could turn it into something, like, down the line, like, but I'm not working with it.
Yeah.
I just can't wait for when we become more popular and people find GSF2 and they're like, why is it called GSF2?
Five soldiers, all armed. If I alert them, they'll kill the hostage and need to reach a vantage point to draw them outside.
Alright. Yeah, this is just teaching me, like, the stealth predator. I really wish I had,
Turn notifications off.
That's like the Discord admin for my Halo Discord. He's probably promoting his clan or something.
Halo clans.
Yeah, I know.
They still exist. Wonder how many Halo clans exist now.
Oh, there's still a good amount. They're just more toxic than they used to be. Like, since modding for that Discord, I realize a lot more. Like, these kids, like, talk about DDoSing and this and that instead of just, like... I did clans for a long time, but, like, when I did it, you'd find another clan, you'd play against them, and you'd win or lose, and that was it. Now it's, like, even if you win, then they start trying to, like, haze you, find out who you are, and all this, like, personal stuff, and I'm like, wow. I don't remember being that much of a virgin.
Yeah, it's, I don't know.
Three more soldiers inside.
Like, the cool part back was, like, getting a ton of people together to do custom games.
Lucius, I've got a hostage situation.
Because it's difficult to do that unless you have like a really large group of friends. Can react.
Yeah.
Is it ready?
Flexible plates over an everything else. Fluid armor layer. You'll move faster, hit harder, and look scarier while doing so.
So I'm about to get the Arkham Knight suit. I've been wearing the Arkham City suit. I'm kind of torn because I prefer the Arkham City suit over the Knight suit. Like, this looks cool. The other one looks cool too, but meh.
Dude, I would love it if instead of it being a hologram, Batman is just carrying around a big monitor on.
Yeah. If you're wearing like the 1960s suit.
Yeah. It's like a CRT.
Yeah. Gotta get the new fresh duds, BB.
Dude, I love his Iron Man suit.
Yeah. It's not far off.
Just reminded me of like in the Iron Man movies when like this suit like gets sent down from like space.
Yeah. No, the suit's not bad, but I very much prefer the other suits. So I might just switch it after a little while.
You're saying you don't like the Ben Affleck skin suit?
Oh, that's the worst. I prefer this over the Ben Affleck, dude. Are you kidding me? I hate the Ben Affleck suit. It tries so hard to be Dark Knight Returns while looking like futuristic, and it's gross.
Yeah, I don't like it either.
All right, Lucius, I don't need the rundown of the suit. I get it. It's cool. Thank you.
The bat pecs.
Yeah.
Don't have the nipples.
The bat titties. I love that there's just... See, here's another thing. I love that there's just a hostage situation in this room, and that's why I changed to the suit. And now he's like, all right, well, go ahead and do all these AR challenges to learn how to use it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Three gunmen, one hostage. Time to put.
I remember most of the combat and stuff, so I'm all good.
The new suit is faster and more mobile. By getting close without being detected, I can get the jump on them. And in the
Dang,
panic, take down all three before they know what's hit them.
Sunset Overdrive.
Next stream, Sunset Overdrive, question mark?
Yeah, maybe. That game has, like, flawless platforming. They really
yeah, it's
refined.
So smooth. I wouldn't say flawless.
Well, yeah, the one thing that I didn't like about
you're
the platforming
now.
Is,
I'll send someone
like,
to pick you up.
Thank you.
It's all emphasized, like, movement is, like, the most important part in the game, and they make movement feel really good.
Mm-hmm.
The problem is when you stop moving, like, when you're on, like, a road or like, you're on the ground and you're not moving, everything starts falling apart. And, like, that's the point, but it definitely isn't as fun.
I'll be honest with you, I forgot how preferences, yeah, these notifications gotta go.
A lot of the mechanics actually came from Ratchet and Clank. Like a lot of Sunset Overdrive, you're like grinding on different things around the city.
Not yet.
And like bouncing off of like rooftops, and a lot of that actually came from certain Ratchet and Clank games that they made beforehand.
Yeah.
Especially the grinding. Although the bouncy rooftops is
Oracle,
a new one.
I've attached the uplink to the microwave.
They did
tower.
A good
Perfect.
Job with that.
I made an anonymous
it's very weird because like
they're gonna send someone to pick up the
it's
hostage.
Technically an open world platformer.
Come on, connect.
But it doesn't
love the suit, by the way.
It's okay. I'm in the process of writing like I told you. I'm in the process of writing a video essay.
On open worlds,
open
right?
World. About open world platformers.
I need to use both
and
antennas to
a
identify
part of
the micro
that,
and
doing the research
wave
for that, I'm looking into like how
if I can find
open world
frequencies at the same
games
location,
are designed
I'll
and how platformers
Scarecrow
are designed
because
open world platformer kind of uses both,
mm-hmm.
and sometimes games kind of stray more into one than the other. Like sometimes it's marketed as like an open world platformer,
the
but it's really just an open world game with
chemicals.
Platforming,
That's
or it's a platformer with.
Toxin.
Open world mechanics. It's very.
Here,
it's not.
I traced the fear toxin to Ace
like
chemicals.
the actual
that
sheer amount of
here.
Just open Impossible. World, like pure open world platformers is actually really small.
Yeah.
There's not a ton of them. because a lot of them kind of have mechanics of one. It's like when people mix up sandbox and open world. Like there are a lot of open world games that have sandbox mechanics, and most sandboxes are open world.
Mm-hmm.
It's like saying like a rectangle is a square, but a square is not a rectangle.
No, I get you. I'm excited. I can't wait for that to come out.
Yeah, I'm excited to do. I found some research theses about like game design. Like one's on platform game design, another one is on level design and open worlds. Yeah. And another one is just on and another one's on open world game video game design. So like when I was writing it, I wanted to like go into like, oh, how, like what exactly is an open world platformer, and like what would be my qualifications for like a true open world platformer. And
I wanted to ask, do you see open world games as a fad or a necessity now, like a standard?
They definitely, so this relates to a lot of a part of the video essay that I was writing, where a lot of things in video games come and go as bad based on the technology of the time. So mm-hmm. like, you ever wonder why big video game companies stopped doing platformers? It's not because they lost their love for doing platformer games.
It's that they don't sell as well.
No, it's not. Well, it's not even that. It's that platformers used to be the only kind of game you could make, unless you were doing like a or fighting game. Like if you were doing like an interactive game that wasn't like an arcade one, one of the only kinds of games you could do were platform games.
Mm-hmm.
And so platform games lend themselves to more cartoony styles. And more realistic stuff didn't necessarily work out until early 2000s when you had like GTA coming out, and that was like open world sandbox.
Yeah.
And then so that sold like hotcakes, and so a lot of people were like, oh, we can start doing this with technology now. So more and more people with new technology totally were like, I don't want to do platforming by necessity. I want to do this new stuff.
Friend of yours?
And then eventually that stuff becomes so popular that they end up never going back to platforming.
I'll go find out.
It's why Naughty Dog hasn't done anything but realistic shooters since Uncharted.
Yeah.
Open world started, like, open world sandboxes, a lot of them started because they were just trying to like, copy the success of like early GTAs, because it was like that like set the standard for those kind of games.
I feel like they're still setting the standard, because I argue Red Dead 2 is one of the best open worlds of all time.
Ever since they're getting out on Discord.
Am I?
Oh yeah, I hear you now. Ever since
the Arkham Knight. Tech into
like,
their comms.
Like early 2000s, there are a lot of GTA clones,
there's a crew
and there are a lot of games that utilize open world
to help us track
sandboxy-ish
his bomb.
Mechanics, but maybe necessarily wasn't like a GTA clone. A lot of games nowadays will still use open world. Like Horizon Zero Dawn is all open. Skyrim is technically open world.
Each one armed and dangerous.
Fallout
if I can access
is open
that terminal,
world.
I'll need to take them down.
And open world has existed since like the first Legend of Zelda.
Mm-hmm.
It's just that open world platforming didn't really happen until like the early 2000s, late 90s.
And even then, I have difficulty counting some open world platformers as open world. They're more just 3D platformers. Like Banjo and Banjo and Kazooie, you might think are open world platformer, but they have a hub world. And hub worlds are just our level selectors, essentially. It's not technically open world. Abigail, what did I miss? I had to eat dinner. Not much. We've just been chatting, having a chill stream. Tom's been getting through more forward in the game.
Yeah, I'm trying to knock out these guards and get into Ace Chemicals currently, because that's a thing.
Yeah, boy.
But I mean, if I'm being honest, I prefer games to be open world, but that doesn't. I don't like the idea of it. You don't have to have an open world game. Oh shit, they saw me.
Oh yeah, no, I agree. I think they're.
Oh, I died. I got hit, Noel. It happened.
Oh no.
GG.
Yeah, no, I agree. I don't think open world is required to be, have a good game. And I think a lot of times, unless you go, unless like, open world itself is its own kind of level design. And if you don't intend for everything to relate to the fact that it's open world, you shouldn't make an open world game.
I agree.
And it, then that's where a lot of open world platformers struggle with, is sometimes they focus too much on it being open world that they forget it's a platformer, and then suddenly the open world doesn't influence the platforming as much.
Yeah.
And then sometimes you have platformers that are open world that don't really focus as much on the open world aspect and focus more on the platforming. And it's a really difficult balance, because the decision making is, where do I draw the line? Is it, does the platforming have to override everything else because it's a part of the gameplay, or does the open world have to take center stage? And I kind of argue that platforming has to relate. If you're gonna call yourself a platforming game, everything has to relate to platforming. So if it's open world, you still have to have all the open world mechanics, but it also has to be tied into the platforming, which is difficult to do. And one of the reasons why it's so difficult is because a lot of open world games aren't built to be anything other than realistic.
Yeah.
It's very like in a 3D platformer, a cartoony platformer, you can do whatever kind of platforms you want. Like, they are just the level's platforms, and it can look however ridiculous it wants. But in open world, there's a reason for everything looking the way it is. And so, if you don't have the story and the world design laid out properly, you get these like really goofy looking like platformy open world levels, it's not Banjo-Kazoo, it's the modern one with the bat and the Ukulele has these like really funky worlds, and it's like technically an open world platformer, but it's in like more like Banjo and Kazooie. But Banjo and Kazooie, like I don't know, Ukulele is arguably not open world because it also has the hub world. But
Ukulele is a game I always wanted to check out, but I never did.
It's not very good.
No? Tyler says it's good.
Well, just because Tyler...
No one ever said he had good taste.
Just because Tyler enjoys it doesn't mean it's a good game. Like, Banjo-Kazooie, the worlds are really much larger than they have to be. So you're like... Imagine like a Banjo-Kazooie game, but really bloated. And so you're like running around and doing kind of not like nothing for a lot of it. Yeah, it's got a lot of issues. Let's see, chat. My brother is currently playing The Last of Us. I'm trying to watch this. Oh, well, thank you for watching the stream.
Noel is not a fan of The Last of Us, but I love it. He has a personal hatred of The Last of Us because it's not Jack.
I have a personal bias against The Last of Us because it canceled the Jack project at night.
It didn't cancel the Jack project. They weren't actually making one.
So the when Night Dog's anniversary came out, they released like a documentary and like they released a bunch of artwork for like their scrap projects, and they talked about a lot of their scrap projects, and one of them was their Jack 4 project.
The facility first.
And they had intended to make a Jack 4 coming off of it was like post Lost Frontier, post Uncharted. So like a few years before The Last of Us came out. And they said that they couldn't figure it out, but they ended up scrapping whatever they did for Jack 4 and they put that into Last of Us. They basically scrapped the Jack team and they reassembled it and added a bunch more people and they made the Last of Us team. But like Last of Us low-key killed Jack and Daxter at Naughty Dog.
I'm okay with that.
Yeah, a lot of people are. A lot of people love The Last of Us.
They
can't... That's totally okay. Like it's still a it deserves all those awards. I just have a personal bias against it.
And that's a real shame because I feel like you deny yourself a good game.
I've seen a Let's Play of it. It's just, I don't know, personally, it's not the kind of game that I love playing.
Yeah, you were always more interested in, like, more lighthearted and...
I mean, not always. I've played quite a few serious and more scarier games.
First,
but
I need to investigate
the one thing I don't love about what The Last of Us did to the gaming industry is that post Last of Us, so many games try really hard to be like The Last of Us, where it's like, let's put in a crap ton of like movie cutscenes into our game.
Oh, I didn't realize. Oh,
what have I started? Yeah. Like, so many video games, because of the technology, they can, like, make all these, like, really elaborate movie-like cutscenes. And, like, that's cool and all, but I like playing the video game. I don't like watching the movie in my video game. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I know what you mean.
It's just a personal opinion. It doesn't necessarily make it good or bad. It's just how I feel.
No, I feel ya. I mean, it's not like you go out of your way to trash talk it either. But I mean, I am very excited for The Last of Us 2.
Oracle.
I feel like
one of the workers.
The Last of Us is kind of like game, like Oscar bait equivalent for the video games.
Yeah, but I don't think that's really what they try to go for. It's not like they just made a good game.
Found a way to get the Batmobile into the compound.
It's definitely
for this. All of them.
Very dramatic.
Yeah, but that's kind of Naughty Dog's thing now. I mean, Uncharted games are kind of dramatic, which I'm not really into the Uncharted games. They're just not my cup of tea.
Yeah, it's really funny that Uncharted 2 got Game of the Year because it's almost the exact same game as Uncharted 1.
Oh no! I goofed.
Oh no. Don't goof, Tom. Last of Us 2 is actually really similar to Uncharted 2 is really similar to Uncharted 1. It's just that Uncharted 1 came out in a really awkward point, and so it didn't really get noticed very well. And then Uncharted 2 came out the year that was really bad for video games, and so it was like one of the only good video games that came out that year. So by comparison, it got Game of the Year, and then from there, everyone was like, ooh, Uncharted! Have you two heard of the book series Dune? Isn't there a movie? Isn't there like a really old Dune movie that's like 4 hours long?
I've never heard of it. I don't know.
Yeah, I am familiar with the series. I've never heard of it.
I can launch myself now.
Yo, I like how all the bad guys are all, they're all like, yes, let's all have Team Red outfits.
Yeah, that's just the look. That's like the Arkham Knight look, which the Arkham Knight, I'll talk about him later. I'm not fond of his character. And the game's named after him, so that's not a good thing, but I mean, I just... I'll tell you later. Oh, now I fight ninjas. Cool. Yeah, these are basically reskins of enemies from the second game.
Gotcha. So they reuse a lot of stuff.
Oh yeah, that's kind of a thing with the Arkham games though. They reuse stuff a lot, but then add more.
I find it interesting when really popular video games reuse a lot of their prequels assets.
It saves time and development.
Yeah, because like a lot of people are giving flack for the Resident Evil 3 remake, where I don't know if you've seen it. That one's probably worth watching a Let's Play for, because it's a $60 game, but it's got a 4-hour story.
Mm-hmm.
And that's it.
No, yeah, I looked at a review for it, and for what it is, it's good.
It is. But it's a good story. It's just really short, and it's not worth $60.
I can understand that.
But the reason why is because it was actually supposed to be a DLC for Resident Evil 2. Like, it's supposed to come out at the same...
And they just sold it.
Yeah, it's supposed to come out at the same time, but because of development issues, they weren't able to, so... They were like, yeah, let's just release that as its own game, I guess.
Yeah. No, I get that. And I mean, at the same time, like, I think that there's more an issue with them reusing assets because it's already a remake of a game.
Yeah.
Which, so it's like, you're not only remaking, you're not only having to just not even remake a story or anything, you're just really copying the story, but you also at the same time, sorry, I'm like trying to focus and not die while also talking, but like you're also now just a game you made a year ago, you're just reusing assets from that.
Yeah.
Which is kind of dumb. But I mean, when you're coming out with a game a year after like another game, it's gonna happen.
Oh yeah, there's a lot of games that are like that. It is very interesting. I mean, like, the engine is good, and, like, I understand why they wouldn't want to change it. Like, I don't think they've changed it since Resident Evil 7.
Yeah, and I honestly, Resident Evil 7 is the only one I've played, and I love it.
Yeah, Resident Evil 7 is good.
Yeah, it's amazing. But, I talked to Tyler about it, because he was kind of disappointed of it as well. I'll probably get 2 and 3 as a bundle over the summer, just so I have something to play, but that all depends on a lot of things.
2 is worth the $60,
mm-hmm.
For sure. Have they sold them both as like a bundle?
Yeah, they already do. You can already get it as a bundle.
Oh, really? For what price?
I don't know. You'd have to check. You can check it up right now if you want. But I swear I saw it as a bundle, and I'm sure that was the plan.
I've never seen the Doom movies. Just know it's really long and really boring.
That's 2 dead workers
now.
RE2
and 3
I should have stopped this.
Batman, look.
You can buy Resident 2 and Resident 3 together.
I really think you should consider letting him help you. You're up against an entire army.
She's right. We're a team.
That's like a whole thick beagle.
I can handle it, Robin. I've told you what you have to do. Now do it.
This can wait.
No, it can't.
I think Resident Evil. I never really found video games to be scary.
Video games. You should try playing. You should try playing like.
You shouldn't be so hard on Tim. He only wants to
help. I mean, I own it, so I could, but.
You're on the second.
We game share. So I have both.
No, because I know they released Outlast 1 free with live. I don't know.
No, but you bought it, didn't you?
No, I don't think so. I think I was going to buy it because me and Yusuf were going to play it at the time, but I didn't think I ended up buying it.
Well, let's find out.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I never end up buying it.
Quick, what letter comes before O? I know I have one of the Outlasts on here.
Yeah, no, Outlast 1 was free with Xbox Live. I didn't buy the second one.
Yeah, but where is it?
Well, I didn't buy it, so if you have it, then you bought it.
Yeah, but I know I have it.
Where's the first one?
But I don't see it. Are you watching? Like, yeah, I'm on my games and apps right now. Is this in alphabetical order? It is.
Yeah.
There we go. Now I'll definitely find it.
This is good. Oh.
Weird. Maybe it's not in my library. Who knows?
Oh, you know, maybe it's... Oh, maybe you never claimed it as a live game, so it's not...
Jesus.
Oh, you know what? I probably have to. You might have to put my account back on your Xbox.
The back
because I changed
work,
the password.
But I can use the winch on the Batmobile.
Maybe that's why it's not game sharing.
I could have just used the Batclaw to do this, but instead it's like, let me open this window so I can use the Batmobile. And that's just dumb.
Okay, so you can buy both Resi 2 and Resi 3 for $80.
No.
So that's actually worth it if you don't own either of them. Because Resi 2 is worth $20. And Resi 3 is worth $20. And Resi 2 is definitely worth $60. So that's actually a good price. Right? But if you were to buy them separately, it'd be $120.
That's gross.
Yeah, that is really gross. Like, they're both good stories, and they're good gameplay. It's just, Resi 3 doesn't deserve to be $60. If they ever release DLC for Resi 3, it should be operational. I will attack it as if I'm here guarding now. Give me a troll patrolling every damn back alley. I'm excited. I want them to remake Resident Evil 1 again. Because they made a remake before they start doing all the, like, remakes that everyone knows today. And it still has, like, the tank controls and all that stuff. I would love it if they remade it, like these remakes.
They're having me use the Batmobile to raise this elevator, and then get in it as Batman, and then lower the elevator.
This is as high as the elevator will go.
Gameplay.
It's a bad idea.
Hey, this is as high it's as a bad idea to drop the elevator while I'm still inside it.
Are you sure about that?
Okay, now the Batmobile can do nothing for me. Sweet.
Should have retiled this long-standing hatred of the Batmobile.
That's fair.
Oxenfree, lol. Yeah. Yeah, Yusuf remembers when we played Oxenfree. Has anyone else played RE7? I haven't personally played it. Like, I don't.
That's Biohazard, right?
What?
Biohazard is 7, right?
Does it have an... I thought it was just called Resident Evil 7.
No, yeah, it's Resident Evil 7 Biohazard. I played it, and I loved the hell out of it. It's the only Resident Evil game I've played and enjoyed so far. I played 5 and hated it.
I thought it was cool that 7 was ended up being a prequel.
Yeah. Was it a prequel?
Yeah, it's supposed to my knowledge it comes before all of the other ones or like
cuz I know Chris Redfield is in it.
Yeah.
But it definitely borrowed from PT.
Oh, yeah. It took the PT formula, and it just kind of rolled with it. I really like that.
I do, too. PT was amazing. It's a real shame.
Yeah, Yeah, 7 isn't a prequel.
No, I didn't think it was a prequel.
I thought it was because of the umbrella people that come in at the...
I don't know. I don't know the story of Resident Evil, actually. Never a game series I got into. You'd have to ask Tyler.
I thought the point of 7 was that it was like the T virus, because like it, like all those mold people were.
It was supposed to be a soft reboot. I know that because 6 was a flop.
I want to look it up now.
Wow, that's actually impressive. I would never play that game on that house. No, thank you. That game's kind of a grind. Which I liked about it, but at the same time, I swear if I have to use the Batmobile to stop this fan, I'm gonna blow my brains out.
Let's see.
Over here!
You're safe.
Jesus, his eye!
So it takes place after 6, but it's not.
They've been running the plant for hours.
Okay.
They brought in trucks. Weapons, soldiers, ships.
Yeah, that's what I thought. It definitely was not a prequel to the series. No, no way.
I'm not incredibly familiar with all.
We're talking about a gas cloud that could cover the entire.
Yeah, I'm not interested enough to. Oh wait, hold up. Tyler texted me.
All I know is he's moving ahead with his plan, and he's got a whole freaking army backing him up.
The reason I thought it was a prequel is because they
screwed Batman.
I'll stop him.
But first, I'm getting you out of here.
They were coming up with like a new virus.
Have you found Scarecrow?
It actually goes to modern day.
It's worse than I thought.
How much worse?
Yeah, I know RE1.
He's building a bomb big enough to cover the entire East Coast.
Yo, my brothers are ridiculous. Pedro just texted me he wants to play the COD Wars, and he's like, "Yo, Tommy, let's go, or I'm gonna call Ma." She better not. Walk in and be like, Tommy, Pedro wants to play.
So are they gonna make a Resident Evil game that take place after 7?
Yeah, I'm sure. But I think what they want to do is make their money off of these remakes while they can.
Yeah.
And I mean, 4 is like considered the best besides 2, so I'm sure they're gonna remake 4.
Yeah, they're probably gonna take their sweet time.
Fun fact, Resident Evil 2 and 3, when they originally came out, the development time between them is about the same as the remakes. Yeah, so they made 2 and 3 within a year of each other.
Yeah, it's the same thing with, like, Halo 3, where it didn't really take them very long.
No, well, to be fair, Halo 2 came out, I think, 04, and then 3 came out late 07. So that was way longer than a year.
It took them more than a year to make Halo 3. It's like...
Dude, you act like 3 is like a piece of garbage.
It reuses so much from Halo 2, though.
Not really.
It really does. That's why they add in, like, the armor gimmicks.
No, the gameplay mechanic, like, the gameplay itself is pretty much the same. But it's not like they've reused assets. They used the same engine, that's about it.
Alfred,
but I mean, they used the same Halo engine until now.
Oh yeah, that's what I mean. They by reusing the engine, they're
weapons lock deactivated.
Yeah, but I mean, 1 up to 5 is the same engine. The Blam
engine.
Engine
for Halo 4.
Yeah, they do. 100%.
No, they don't.
Dude.
It's a completely different engine.
No, the Blam engine, yes, it's just a modified version of the original engine. They modify it every game.
It's a different engine.
It's not, dude. Look it up. What do you mean?
That's like saying the Unreal 1 engine is the same as the Unreal 2 engine. By just being like, oh, it's all of the Unreal engine.
Well, no. The Blam engine was just modified for each game.
You're cutting out on this
one. Oh, how about now? Better?
You're fucking out.
Noel?
Yes.
Oh, you can hear me now. Yeah, it's the Blam engine. It's been the same until now, and even now, the new engine is just based off the Blam engine.
It's still different, though.
I'm just saying, you immediately went to Halo 4 as an example of it being better.
Well, Halo 3 is a good example. It, like, doesn't really change very much from Halo 2. It was made in a shorter time than 2.
It's
the third game in the series.
No, it's about the same time. Look it up, I don't know. But I'm not arguing with you that it didn't reuse assets, but it wasn't like a blatant copy.
If I don't stop Scarecrow's bomb.
I think what they did was they used the mentality of don't fix what isn't broken. Alright, I gotta figure out what I'm gonna do here. Oh, this is a glitch? Jesus Christ. This Batmobile is going crazy.
Oh, jeez. Oh, that's cool that they're making RE8 and RE4. I bet you they're gonna release RE8 first.
What are they doing?
Apparently RE8 and RE4 are in the works right now.
Uh-huh. Oh, that's cool.
I bet you they're gonna release RE8 first, but if they don't, I wouldn't be too surprised.
I wouldn't really care. Resident Evil isn't, like, my favorite game series.
Yeah.
7 was good. I might get 8. We'll see. Tyler's, like, super into Resident Evil right now. And I think he might have joined stream, or he said he was going to in a little bit. But that horror games is kind of Tyler's thing right now. Which, I mean, there are good horror games, but there are a lot of bad ones.
There's a lot of really bad ones.
It definitely is not my favorite genre.
Horror games are very... Like, good horror games are really fascinating. It's just there aren't a ton of them. Also, a lot of horror games are generally, like, indie games.
Yeah.
That's probably also why you don't know a lot of them.
How the hell do I get the car over here? This is what I'm talking about right here, Noel. I have to get the Batmobile over here to progress, and I don't remember how to do it, so I have to remember. And that's obnoxious. He's Batman. The car is a tool, not the reason why he's still alive.
I don't know what you're talking about. Batman is the car.
You're right. You're absolutely right, Noel. I hate you. Yusuf, did you ever play Arkham Knight? Okay, oh, I gotta get out of the car, park it here, get out of the car, press the button, get back in the car. God!
That's just a bad game design.
Yeah. But the rest of the game is fine, dude. They just like, alright, we're gonna put all this effort in the Batmobile. Let's make use of it. And that, it also ruined the Riddler stuff, too. Because for the Riddler stuff, you have to race with the Batmobile after getting a certain number. That's probably why I never 100%ed this game.
Yeah, aren't there, like, underground sewer races or whatever?
Yeah, and it's whack. And then, like, you can't just 100% this game. You had to 240% it.
You just said he played it, but he never finished it.
Yeah, that's most people. Alright, this is what they want me to do. They want me to... There we go. Okay, and then I'm gonna move it over here. Like, all of this, just so I can get the car... Oh my god, this crane is kind of toxic. Why is the crane inverted? That's good enough. Okay. Jesus Christ, stop moving, crane. Crane. I think I may have stick drift and that's an issue. I don't know.
Maybe.
Okay. Go right to move it that way. Maybe I should have played one of the older ones.
Maybe.
Nah. I still enjoy this game.
There's not many open world games that use vehicles this much. It's kind of difficult to balance. Like, what part...
Oh, no!
Ooh.
I honestly, for what it is, the Batmobile is cool. Like, it's a cool idea. I just think that, and I like that it's in the game. My issue is that they took a cool idea and overused it.
Yeah.
And that's where they made their mistake. If this was just like,
It's probably because the game developers really liked the Batmobile.
Yeah, and that's fine. I understand that. But, like, here's my thing. If the Batmobile was just this mode with, like, a, like, concussion gun like it has to, like, shoot enemies, and like you can still go in car chases and like things. It's the tank mode and how much they use it that bothers me.
Yeah.
So like if the tank mode was like a thing you used maybe 3 times in the whole game, cool, and that would have been a complaint in itself, but like it wouldn't have as annoyed me as much. But like it's the fact that I have to use the Batmobile in almost every situation that's outdoors or semi-outdoors, and that's dumb. And now here comes the other issue I have with this game, is this cuck. So you know how the second Robin is Jason Todd, he died and then came back as like Red Hood.
Sure.
Okay. When people saw this character, they're like, "Oh, this is Jason Todd. He's Red Hood." And the game developers were like, "No, this guy's original. We created him for the game." I'm gonna spoil it now because I don't care. Plot twist. Like, in the last quarter of the game, it was Jason Todd the whole time. And it's just like, you could have just done Red Hood and it would have had the same effect, but no, they had to be all flashy with this stupid-looking Arkham costume. Because they had to have Arkham in the game.
It could be that there was a development change, like,
no,
part of the way through. They like, decided to change it.
It's just like, it's dumb. I have the colors in watercolor and Sharpie.
No.
I'm so conflicted on what to use. Use green. I like green. Sir. Green and blue. What do you think, Noel?
I like green. Fully intend to kill you. But first, we're going to make you suffer. We have the target. Green is always a good color.
Just say the word. Can I use the okay, Noel. So guess what I have to do to get out of this situation? Take a guess, Noel.
It's your favorite mechanic.
I know.
I find it very interesting how...
See, the Batmobile assist is kind of cool, but like...
Yeah.
It's just overused.
I find it interesting how it's kind of open world platformy, but there isn't like a designated area for the Batmobile. Like the Batmobile just kind of goes all over the place, wow, even in this like really tight knit.
That's especially for this area, but like there's gonna be plenty of other areas where I'm indoors and there isn't a Batmobile, thankfully. I think that it's more apparent now because this is the tutorial sort of. We're still more or less in the prologue, but like, even when it opens up, you're still gonna use the Batmobile a lot. But like, it's not a bad game. It's just it does a couple things that bother me, and it's why it's the weakest of like the big three. Origins is just a carbon copy of City in a lot of ways, and a lot of people like it, but I don't. But I'd say it's the weakest, but this is the second worst. It's good, but it's one and two just are amazing. I'm going after him. Is it as bad
as it sounds? Worse, Jim. But I'll stop. I don't know. I just found it so.
Look at the car seat. Look at the little car seat.
And it's like a roller coaster.
Yeah.
I just found it interesting that the Batmobile is in this spot that like you'd think that that's made for like Batman to walk through, not for the car to drive in.
Yeah.
Like look how tight knit this is. Like you're like preparing the bomb in the central mixing chamber. Low key like almost falling off the building.
Yeah. Like moments like this, Batmobile's cool. I like it when it's just the car, you know. It's all the tank stuff I could do without, but I'm not gonna complain about that the whole stream. What's up, Wolfpack? And I thank you for joining the stream. We're just playing some Arkham Knight and complaining about the Batmobile, of course.
Oracle, I need that route to Scarecrow. Hey, yo, he's completed the entire game. You're not gonna like
this. Yeah, I have too. I haven't 240%ed it, but I definitely beat it when it first came out. I haven't played it since like 2016, but I recently replayed Asylum and City, so I thought I'd stream. I really gotta. Okay, I see what I have to do. I gotta go back to the crane.
He agrees that. I think he's saying that he agrees the tank isn't bad.
Yeah, that's the general consensus. Jesus Christ. Noel, take controls. Please. Find a way.
Yo, what if this game was like Mario Galaxy, where the second player
first,
just
we need to focus on stopping
the Batmobile? Oh my god. That would make this a lot more bearable. I'd be down. Alright. There. It's perfect. Alright. Alright, I'm out of here. Huh?
We're playing Galaxy.
When the quarantine is over?
Yeah.
When we finish Sunshine and, like, Hat in Time.
Because I wanted to do 3 as well, but 3 is very short. It won't take
long. They made a Mario Galaxy 3?
No, just Mario 3.
Oh. Yeah, that'd be cool. Oh, look! Tanks!
Co-op. You can do it co-op.
I'd be down.
Yeah. A Mario 3, just because, like, I don't know, I've never... If you can play the original Mario 3 for, on the Switch,
uh-huh.
But the Mario 3 that a lot of people prefer, including myself, is the SNES remake, and I don't know if they put that on the Switch yet, but if they did, then I'd love to play that, but if not, we can play the original. Mario 3 is like the Mario that all the other Mario since then have kind of like based off of.
Not to interrupt you, Noel, but don't worry, Wolfpack. I already talked about the Jason Todd thing and my issues with it. You don't have to worry about spoilers for this.
Oh yeah.
Except for the person that Batman's going to be seeing soon, in Ace Chemicals. Don't spoil that. I want to save that for Noel. But continue, Noel.
I don't remember where I was talking. What was I talking about? I was talking about,
Everything, I'll say this about the game. Everything that's great about the series is still in this game. But I think that they just felt like they had to add more than what they had done in the past, and the Batmobile was the clear, like, simple way of adding another layer to the gameplay. I would have been more than happy if they just cut the Batmobile out of the game for the most part, and then just had the game as it is.
Dig in and do what you can, Jim.
Yeah. I remember what I was saying. Stop the explosion. All the side-scrolling Marios, they all borrow from.
I'm actually on Xbox One, Wolfpack. You were saying no, sorry.
A lot of the side-scrolling Mario, even some of the 3D ones, they all stem from the 3 mechanics, which is really cool. Like I don't know, like me and Tyler both go back and forth on which we think is the best Mario. Like he likes Mario World, and Mario World has a lot of weird stuff in it that doesn't get repeated a lot, and like that's cool, but. Mario 3 has a is the most influential one. And I don't know, it's the most fun one for me. So I had it originally on the Game Boy, and used to be able to hook up Game Boys and do like a co-op, but I never managed to do it because I didn't have the cable to connect the 2 Game Boys. Did you ever end up having that cable?
What cable?
There's like a cable that you can connect 2 Game Boys to each other so that they can play the same game.
No, I never got anything like that.
It didn't come with the Game Boy. I think it's like the Fox cable or something. It had like a name, but there's a couple of Game Boy games that were co-op and you could play.
My Game Boy Advance I used for just a very small amount of games because it was my brother's. So I had, like, a He-Man game on there, I had the original Sonic games on there, and that was pretty much it. And then I got a DS, and that's when I got Pokemon, Mario 64, games like that.
Abigail, I'm worried about my girlfriend. She likes the cold things, and it's worrisome. We'll be more specific.
What did she say? I can't read right now. I'm beating people up.
It says, I'm worried about my girlfriend. She likes occult things. It's worrisome.
She like, what does that mean? What is that? I'm scared. That? No, look it up.
Well, no. Well, like, the occult is like, it can mean a lot of things, but like, specifically, like, I'm not sure exactly what that means. For all I know, it could just mean she really likes Doom Eternal. Do you still get notifications for when people comment on videos?
In our videos?
Yeah.
I think I do, but I don't check them.
Oh, okay.
I'm not sure.
We still get comments. I don't know why, but we still get comments on the Dark Souls 3 live E3 trailer reaction.
Oh my god. That's awesome.
First of all, I don't know who is searching for Dark Souls 3 E3 trailer reaction videos. Well, for some reason, so many people keep watching it and just crapping all over because it's a horrible video of art. Only Ace
Chemicals. Sorry, we didn't know what Dark Souls was at the time. We could look at it and be like, oh, Dark Souls!
What I find so funny is that we were doing that with Daeshar on our show.
Uh-huh.
And he kept cutting out, so we couldn't hear him until the very end of it. And apparently the entire time he was like, oh, it's Dark Souls. And then at the very end, afterwards, like, oh, it's Dark Souls? I didn't realize it's Dark Souls because I had never played Dark...
I didn't play Dark Souls until literally over the course of last year. I just finished Dark Souls the other day.
Yeah, I had barely known anything about Dark Souls.
Oh, so your girlfriend's into summoning demons. I mean, hey, to each their own as long as she's not hurting anyone, you know? I have close friends who do worse, like Tyler. Tyler likes Apple.
Yeah, oh yeah, you're right. Let's not go there.
I'm joking.
He
just goes on stream and just starts talking.
Dude, I find it so funny that she likes watching. I find it so funny that Tyler is like, tonight. It's like, yeah, let's get all the boys into the mixer stream, and then whenever it's the YouTube stream, he's like...
Well, I text him, let's see if he said anything. Mike and I are playing Animal Crossing right now. Why on YouTube? He asked me why on YouTube.
Yeah, I don't know why he has such a YouTube bias. I am very intrigued by this conversation that Abigail is putting in the chat. I have no idea. What do you mean tries to do it?
So she tries to summon demons. I need to stop the chemicals
being loaded into the chamber. Yeah, I want to.
Well, I mean, I don't think it's harmful because demons don't exist. But at the same time, if it worries you, then you should bring it up with them.
I mean, personally, a little bit of a red flag.
Well, don't say that. I mean, yeah, if it were me, that'd be a red flag, but don't say something like that.
I say to each their own.
Yes, to each their own. As long as it's not a detriment to your relationship, I wouldn't worry too much about it.
I agree. Unless a real demon gets summoned.
Yeah, unless she tries to summon demons, like...
Tom, how would you feel if mid-date somebody tried... Your significant other tried summoning a demon?
What's the weirdest date? I'll answer that question with another question. What's the weirdest thing that's ever happened to you on a date? Is that a question you can answer?
Sorry, you cut out when you asked the question.
Oh, my question is, what's the weirdest thing that's ever happened to you on a date? May I remind you that we are on a
tight schedule here. You keep cutting out for me. Are you asking what's the weirdest thing that's ever happened on a date for me?
Yeah.
Definitely Tyler walking up and saying the fetus to the latest joke.
Oh, was this a date with that girl that you went on with Riley?
Yeah, in high school. Izzy.
I didn't know he did that.
He's not cutting out in the stream. He's just cutting out.
Yeah, we're in a Discord call right now, and I'm cutting out. I feel like the weirdest thing's ever happened to me.
The fetus deleted story.
Yes, but let me finish what we were talking about. If we were at a McDonald's and she was trying to exorcise a demon or summon a demon, I'd be down. But if we're in a nice restaurant and like I bought a really good steak and like she summons a demon on my steak, I'd be a little annoyed.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What if the demon was Salt Bae and he salted your steak and then he hand fed it to you?
Yeah, I'd be a little upset. I'd be okay if the demon was like, I don't understand it. Why didn't you try the Big Mac? Oh Jesus. Oh Jesus. Well, that's my first death. Oh, Izzy's here. Hello, Izzy.
Yeah, Izzy's here. Look at me while you die, Batman. Dude, my phone keeps vibrating. I don't know why. Restarted.
It's trying to pleasure you.
I think it's like, I think there's like a notification, like an alert. But it wasn't loading.
Well, I failed there.
Tonight is the night that Gotham changes forever.
Hello, Izzy. Yo, we just have Izzy on the Discord call?
No. No, Noel. Izzy's like, Izzy? She's here now? But, what were you gonna say before I cut you off with the weirdest date thing?
I don't remember what our conversation was.
I don't remember either. Izzy, answer in chat. How would you feel if Noel exercised a demon during a date?
Once I clear the room, I can focus on stopping the explosion.
What if by summoning a demon during the date, I also summon the Doom Slayer? I feel like that would make up for it.
Yeah. If Noel, if you want, Noel, you can add her to the Discord call. I don't care.
No, it's fine.
She's like, why not? You're just not Batman enough for this.
Yeah. It's up to you, Tom.
Yeah, I don't care. You can add her if you want.
Did I tell you the video idea that I'm gonna be doing with Izzy?
No, you didn't tell me.
You know those? I think Izzy shared the video, but like the videos where like you have generally some person will have like their girlfriend or their mom or their daughter or whatever like guess like character names.
Oh jeez.
By like looking at pictures.
Don't tell me you're gonna do Fire Emblem.
Yeah.
I hate you, dude. Why?
I wanna have Izzy guess all of the Fire Emblem character names.
Why can't it be a good game?
Why can't it be a good game? Are you kidding me?
Yeah. Dude, Fire Emblem is just weeb chess. Change my mind.
It's gonna be so funny because, one, it's hilarious to watch people guess anime characters, but two, all of the characters don't overlap in names. They're all unique names.
Go for it. Izzy answered, by the way. She said, I would be a bit impressed. Depends if the demon is good company. If he wants a threesome, I'm not down. Izzy also, I should mention, Izzy's the one who coined the term weeb chess for Fire Emblem, and that is the greatest thing I've ever heard in my life.
Well,
I quote it weekly.
Weeb chess, I mean, it's not her title. Lots of people call weeb chess.
No, would you have a threesome with a demon?
No.
No? Yeah, me either. So to answer your question in a long-winded way, Abigail, whether or not it's a deal breaker or a red flag is up to you.
I think it would be a deal breaker if you were the Doom Slayer.
Yeah. But I mean, at the same time, it might not be a deal breaker. It depends what he means by rip and tear.
Yeah. Rip and tear.
I am Izzy's biggest fan. I completely agree with that statement, but Izzy's also my biggest fan. Okay. So, Noel, all this work I've been doing in here, guess why?
Why?
Because I gotta get the Batmobile in here.
Oh my God.
I'm like deep into the cheeks of this building, and I'm still expected to bring my car into here. I hate this game. Alright, so where do I go? Let me ask Batman.
I need to get the car into this area.
Oh, well, who would have thunk?
You're even more of
Yeah.
Obviously, Batman is the car, and the car controls what you think
the
is
the person.
Batman.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah. I'm playing Batmobile Arkham Knight right now.
Abigail's right. Why are you being mean to the Batmobile? The Batmobile loves you, Tom.
You're right, Abigail. The Batmobile just wants to please me, and here I am. I can't get over those spikes, are you kidding me?
Yeah.
Here I am just talking shit about it. There we go. Okay.
Yo, that's the deal breaker in your relationship with the Batmobile.
Yeah, I would not have a threesome with the Batmobile.
With the Batmobile?
Yeah, no. I'd have a threesome with Batman, I guess. But I take that back. I never said that. That never was said. But anyway, I definitely wouldn't have a threesome with the Batmobile. Okay, can I just... did I need to go in the back? Okay, I didn't need to... Okay, cool. I can just go here.
Do you really think you've won?
I guess.
Fear makes you predictable. I am in complete control.
Whoa, this is getting kind of kinky. What if the Batmobile just barges in?
How do I shut it down?
I mean,
or she dies. What are you talking about?
Barbara Gordon.
That part's a little gay for old Brucey.
Yusuf would most certainly have a threesome with Batman.
Relax. No one knows I'm here.
Barbara Gordon, she's Batgirl. She's paralyzed though, so she's not Batgirl, she's Oracle.
Nothing hurts.
Yeah, she was Batgirl.
Yeah.
Knowing that there is no one to blame but yourself.
This game is not good for disabled people. It tells them
Alfred.
That they can't become Batgirl.
It tells paralyzed people that they can't walk.
Keep trying.
Yeah.
All right. So currently the game's at 3 stars. It's gonna get back to 4 in a minute or two.
I'm not trying to stop it, but I can reduce the blast radius.
Oracle is making me think of last night when I was watching a,
Find her, Alfred.
I agree with Yusuf.
This good man's got money. I gotta secure the bag. Yeah, that's true. I was watching a bunch of sketch comedy last night, and there was a sketch comedy bit where they were, like, making fun of, like, movies where, like, when, like, the cool kid is the one that smokes. And so they would, like, have these little comedy bits where, like, they'd play these, like, kids, and then they'd smoke, and then you'd hear, like, this, like, jazzy music, and they'd, like, go along with those jokes. And then they one of the parts of the bit is they have this kid in a wheelchair, and then
slow and
he
steady.
the kid gets peer pressure into smoking, and he's like, I can walk again. And then the sketch ends with like a spot with like the kid's spine cracking. He's like, wait, no, I can't.
Oh jeez, dude, you know what these remind me of? I'll see if you guess. The in Monsters Inc. when they have the kids scream and it fills
tank.
It up, yeah, and it's kind of it almost makes you think it might be a reference because this is the neutralizing
Dude,
agent for the
obviously
fear toxin.
It's filled with, obviously, that's the laughter tank.
Yeah, but yeah, I have to insert it. I had to insert the neutralizing agent.
Yo, don't do that.
And I have to do it really slowly, or else it'll blow up.
Oracle is just watching like Batman.
Just like
me.
Yeah, Batman, why don't you do this with me anymore since I'm handicapped? And then the Mountain Dew gets in the tube and I gotta grab another.
Yeah, that dude, Batman's a gamer.
Where is he, Alfred?
Yo, have Batman.
I love that Batman's like, where is Barbara? And Alfred's like, ugh.
That's really suggestive. This is oddly sexual. I need a moment. Well, there.
See, Noel, I have to be really slow and steady with these. These cylinders are like a fine woman. They're here to neutralize the fear toxin.
Uh-huh.
I thought Izzy would enjoy that one, Noel. Fuck you. Fuck you for not lying. I mean, laughing. Oh, God.
It's because you cut out. I didn't hear the punchline.
Oh, well, you'll hear it in stream, I guess.
No, I'm not.
Wait,
I
Noel.
What if I
just put it in and pull it out?
You're going to make Poison Ivy jealous.
She's going to look at her like hibiscus and be like, you never do that with me anymore.
How come you don't touch my rhododendron like that?
Oh, wait. I think this is the part.
Dude, make Batman do some schmooves. There we go.
I'm monitoring that facility.
This is like a really intense moment. Batman's just like, do the right thing, that's all that matters.
Life is like a glass of fine wine made of grapes. If this is about Miss Gordon, you cannot blame yourself for what's happened. Save
yourself before it's too late. I'm enjoying this so much.
So much schmoovin'.
He's got to keep those thighs thick, Izzy. Why are you judging him? He's got to stay. He's got to stay fit during the quarantine.
If Batman's not thick, you must acquit.
Yeah.
I think breaking down Batman, breaking it down. This is factual.
Push. What if I just intentionally blow it up? I'm tempted, but I'd have to do this all over again.
Yeah, it's not worth it. Yo, what if this just goes to credits and it's just a Mountain Dew commercial?
Yeah.
Is it possible for you to run out of time?
No, there's no time limit.
I feel like there would be a timer on the top of the screen if there was.
Joker. For the record, to remind you, old Joker's supposed to be dead.
Was that Joker real?
You'll find... No, I might as well... So, a cool thing is, in the second game, Joker injects Batman with, like, his diseased blood... to make him help find a cure for, you know, giant Joker in the first game, right?
Yeah, Hulk Joker.
So, Joker died from it, and Batman got the antidote, so he was able to save himself. Now I'm playing as Gordon. He's able to save himself, and Joker died, but another side effect of the Joker blood is that Batman is slowly going insane.
Oh, okay.
And Joker also sent the blood to a couple hospitals, so he's not the only one.
That's how you get HIV.
Yeah, so now I'm middle-aged commissioner, and I have to go inside this place and do things.
Corona. Hey, I mean, I guess the J in Magic Johnson stands for Joker.
Yeah. Wait. That's horrible.
Can we get it from the chat?
The Grey Ghost. So a couple Easter eggs, because I'm a nerd and we have some time in the elevator. The Terror is a play on of the original movie that Bruce Wayne saw with his parents. The original movie was Zorro, and The Grey Ghost is an animated series reference, and then The Flying Graysons, and then The Prosecutor, which is just random.
Oh my gosh, Izzy's being adorable.
Oh my god, Izzy!
What the hell is this place?
Izzy thinks I can't stop her, bans her from the stream.
Yeah. This is Batman's special sauna boutique.
Goliath.
Don't tell me. You are the police commissioner.
Yo, why are you looking at Jared Leto?
I know, right?
This is Jared Leto Joker.
Nah, that's kind of an insult onto this guy. Johnny C doesn't do Johnny C.
Jared Leto. Controversial statement. Jared Leto doesn't deserve
it's
that.
You, Commissioner Boredom. What have you done with my soulmate? If you try to come between
everyone just turning into the Joker.
I'll carve you a smile so wide, your head falls.
Why do they all have green hair and the white?
Because they're infected with the Joker.
Does the Joker just like naturally have?
You cut off, Noel.
Oh, does the Joker just naturally have green hair?
No, he fell into a vat of chemicals and it turned his hair green.
Commissioner, thank God.
No, I know the acid.
Because it was a backstory made in the 40s, Noel. Alright, are you ready for dummy thick Batman jump scare? Oh wait.
Yes.
It's supposed to happen. Aw, damn it.
Izzy doesn't like jump scares. Why are you bullying
Izzy? It's not that bad. It's not that bad.
It's just Freddy Fazbear comes out.
Yeah. Do I just keep spinning? There
Batman.
Oh my god.
You need to see this.
Yeah, he fell into a vat of chemicals.
What is this?
Or acid,
place?
It depends.
Who are these people?
I never really liked the acid bat
Joker
origin.
Sent his infected blood out to all
yeah.
the hospitals in the state.
I mean,
I know, we tracked it all down.
It's just goofy.
It's not super important anyway.
How?
Hospital. I thought it was kind of freaking. You know I hate FNAF.
Five people were affected.
That's where I made the joke.
Joker, yeah, they all have coronavirus. That's just the way it is.
I knew it was coming, and I was still scared by
Joker.
Batman.
My God.
Do you prefer the origin from
it's
Joker?
It's a form of Creutzfeldt-Jakob.
That one is cool.
But mutated beyond anything.
What'd you say?
Record.
What about that one? The origin they give the Joker
like
the newest movie.
Henry Adams. He's been infected the longest, but he's symptomless.
I can't hear you on
Joker's blood.
No, I'm talking now. What?
I've got Robin.
What do you think of, what's your favorite Joker?
My favorite Joker?
Your favorite Joker origin?
Well, they're all basically the same. Definitely the Killing Joke in animated series. Definitely not the Joker one, because that one, nah. That one is like a real world one, and it's cool, but I don't like it as if it was the comic book origin. I think it's too plain.
I don't know. I know there's no like one origin, but I think it would be cooler. I personally find that like not every character has to have an origin story.
I agree.
Like Joker does better not having one.
And the every oh wait, Mark Hamill.
Can you hear me, Bruce?
I don't know, like, some characters I think definitely deserve to have origin, but not everyone has to have one. Like, it's not always that important.
Me's stuck deep inside you. That's so gross.
Me's stuck
deep inside you. I prefer the animated series and Killing Joke version, but it's usually the vat of acid. The general consensus is that his origin story is multiple choice. He doesn't have a single one.
Yeah, I know.
And, I mean, he doesn't... I don't pay attention to the origin story, to be perfectly honest with you. I mean, if I... Since we're talking about it, we're inside Ace Chemicals, which is where he became Joker. That's kind of the thing.
I just, like, I don't know. The Vat of Acid story just, like... As a chem major, it just makes
yeah, me... Yeah, no, I get that.
I don't know, it's comic book magic.
Did you change your name to Jason Todd Wolf? Oh my god.
Yeah, he did.
What was I gonna say? So yeah, for the rest of this game, Joker's just gonna show up here and there and just comment and just meme. And that's probably the best part of this whole game, because sometimes he's legitimately funny.
That's good. That Harley Quinn animated series that I keep seeing ads for.
Harley Quinn, the animated series, I think is its name.
The TV one, the one that's on. DC.
The one, yeah, Harley Quinn, the animated series.
The voice of Joker, isn't that the voice of Ludo?
Yeah, it is. And you know, honestly, since you brought it up, the show itself isn't bad. It's like the Rick and Morty of DC shows, but it's not great either.
It looks kind of crappy.
No, it's not. I wouldn't say it's crappy. I'd say it's alright. Whoa, Michael Bay.
Yeah,
but
like,
it's watchable. I think the comedy's okay, but like,
it looks a little big. Why? How come all the trailers are so fan servicey?
Because that's the whole show.
Oh, okay. I didn't know if that was actually the whole show. That was just.
Yeah, I watched the first season. I liked it. It wasn't bad, but it's not like, whoa, this is amazing.
Yeah, it didn't seem...
DC Universe is just trying to have, like, a broad catalog of shows for their streaming service, and I'll give them credit for that. Because at least they're doing that while Disney comes out with, like, one Star Wars thing every 6 months.
That's fair.
Fun... Oh, by the way, on May the 4th, since it's Star Wars Day, they're going to have a documentary for The Mandalorian come out, and they're also going to have the last episode of Star Wars The Clone Wars come out, which is cool. Yeah.
But it's over now.
I never really celebrated May the 4th, but...
I haven't either, but I mean, like...
My AP history teacher... was a huge Star Wars fan. She'd always celebrate.
Commissioner Gordon has been trying to contact you.
Thanks, Alfred. Jim.
Yeah, so, Mr. Gordon, about your daughter,
I need to speak to you.
Sure. What is it?
Meet me outside GCPD prisoner detention. I'm heading there now.
Best part is, these dudes have just been in this Batmobile, I think. Or no, they got him out.
That would be so funny if they're just in there the whole time.
Yeah, Batman's got like little TVs in there, like you'll have in the backseat of like a mom van.
Troop deployment.
They're just watching Hunchback.
I want to know exactly what I'm up against.
Yeah, what are we gonna watch?
Oh Jesus! I've been targeted. All right, I'm not doing this whole like I gotta fight these tank guys while I'm trying to play the actual game. I don't feel like it. At least I can control. Oh my god. Alright, well, I guess I don't have a choice. Alright, cool.
It's so, like, weird looking to see such a big tank move so fast.
Yeah.
It's
and, like another thing, see, the thruster's on the back, but it's making it go fast. Oh, wait, no, never mind. I thought it was activating when I was going side to side.
Dude, the scariest thing ever is when a traditionally slow thing just goes really fast.
Yeah, like an elephant.
I can give this an example, because this is the first thing that pops up in my mind. In Dota 2, there's like a really fat character, and he's like... He's pretty scary design. Imagine like a fat zombie that like killed you by like hooking you.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, when he has like a European accent. In the game you can get a power up that like lets you move at max speed. And so seeing
he just referenced Killing Joke, that's cool. Yeah.
Yeah. Seeing that character run at you full speed is the scariest thing in that whole game.
Batman's yeah.
What's
your
wrong,
daughter's dead.
Jim.
Come on, you're scaring me.
It's Barbara. She's been taken.
No. I spoke to her. She said she got out. She left hours ago.
Stay calm. We'll get her back.
Which one? Who's got my little girl?
Scarecrow. They took her from the clock tower.
All right, we need to go. There could be a
probably
clue.
Going
something
to,
that will lead us to her.
I'll follow. Stay
off commentating this stream in like a few minutes.
Who, you?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll probably end the stream in a couple minutes. I don't know. If you end up taking off.
Jim, I need you to stay focused.
See, why didn't Batman just put him in the Batmobile and take him instead of having to escort him?
There's no way you could have predicted this, Jim.
You know why, Noel? Because this game sucks. No, I'm just kidding.
The whole thing's gone down on my watch.
What if this one game of the year for just because it had the tank?
It was a contender. It definitely got game of the year contender.
Big games like this.
I can't blow it up because there's people inside.
What big game?
Well, this was 2015.
No, I know, it's on that. Oh, Witcher 3 got game of the year there.
Makes sense.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Did you end up watching the Witcher Netflix show?
No, I still haven't watched it.
Hmm.
I don't know, like, I'm not crazy into Witcher.
Neither was I never got into it. I'm not a fantasy guy, if I'm being honest with you.
I like fantasy, but there's a lot of fantasy I draw a line at.
Yeah, for me, like, shows-wise, Game of Thrones is as far as I went. And then game-wise, Dark Souls, probably.
Yeah, I don't know. I find it so interesting that when people think of fantasy, the very first thing that gets thought of is, like, medieval. We're clear.
Yeah, no, it doesn't have to be medieval, but I mean, that's the first thing I think.
There's so many, I feel like there's an overwhelming amount of medieval fantasy.
Yeah.
Not really in fantasy either. Yeah. Funny enough, the only,
No, Abigail, biting your fingers is bad.
Out of time.
It is bad. Yeah, I know, Izzy. Most fantasy is medieval, but I don't know to be.
You cut off in the stream there.
Or I might have just been discovered. Izzy is saying in the chat that most fantasy is medieval. And I was like, yeah, I agree, but I don't know why it has to be that way.
Yeah. So, this is a random question, but since Izzy's listened to us and Noel's here, Avatar after stream?
maybe. I'm getting off in a couple minutes because I want to do stuff with my mom.
Oh, that's cool. Protected by long-range radars and a missile launcher.
Well, maybe Avatar, like, 10 or so.
Yeah.
The remaining drone forces on Bleak Island have been redeployed to protect the clock tower, so expect significant
resistance.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, I didn't cut out from the stream. It,
Thanks, Alfred.
It was just you on your
own. Oh, I forgot it's her birthday. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Well, tell your mom I said happy birthday.
I will. Yeah, my mom has been, like, working all day, but she just finished working at home.
That's awesome.
She's probably gonna make dinner soon.
Yeah, I forgot your mom's birthday was this week.
Yeah, she's turning 38.
Yeah. Isn't she actually turning 43? Or 44, I forget.
44.
Yeah. Good, tell her I said happy birthday.
Yeah, I'll tell everyone that. I see five drones online. He's using high caliber rounds. Titanium tipped,
maybe touch the carbine. Whatever it is, it's ripping us to shreds. Stop him! You didn't specify me, though! What did she say, Noel? Huh?
She said thank you.
Yay!
There are militia troops all over the clock tower, Jim. You'll
Izzy,
be safe in the battle.
My mom is turning 38.
I'll let you know
where
the area is secure.
I'm not just sitting here while you go after those bastards.
Yes, you are, Jim. Barbara wouldn't want you to get yourself killed.
It's not safe to enter without taking out the militia troops on the roof of the clock tower.
I'm probably going to finish up this clock tower area and then I'm going to call it a stream. Alright.
Izzy, haven't I I don't think I've explained this in a video, but ever since my mom, I'd say like the last like 10 years, like every single birthday, we'd
always
be like,
I die fast.
my mom's turning 32, and then when she started turning 40, I can't keep turning 32 every year. I'm like, all right, 36. But this year we were like, let's 38.
But your mom is already pretty young.
Yeah.
Then there's my mom who's like 60.
No, she's 49.
Yeah. She wishes.
Yeah. What the inconsistent Naruto post on the streaming website? What inconsistent Naruto post? He's just one guy. We'll be okay.
Yeah, one guy who just took out a unit of.
Oh, he's talking about. Oh, okay. The where you watch Steven Universe.
Oh, we're not gonna talk about that. We might be watching Steam Universe next week. I don't know. It depends if Izzy's busy.
Has anyone else watched Black Butler? I finished watching it, and I'm working on.
I've seen clips of Black Butler, but I never watched it.
I was forced to watch the pilot a long time ago in high school because of Tyler.
Yeah, I remember.
It was really bad. I didn't like it. It was very disturbing, actually.
Isn't that the one where the maid has a gun?
No.
Then it's not what I'm thinking of. There's an anime.
Aren't most of the characters in Black Butler dudes?
I don't know, dude, but I just know there's an anime where like there's an assassin maid, and I remember the pool attendant that I was friends with at my old complex watched it and loved it.
Yeah. Sebastian is best boy.
I'm gonna be very surprised if this is where he.
There is a female maid with a gun in the show. That's what he said. She's not a main character, okay?
Oh, maybe it's different from what I'm thinking of. I don't know. I should have told no. Oh god. Oh, wait, no. We're not this far ahead in the story. What? Well, Noel, I guess we're going to find out how she became paralyzed.
I guess.
Colleen? Is that you again?
Colleen?
Yo, what?
Threesome with Batman?
No.
Threesome with Batman? Oh shit. Off.
Well, that sucks. Can we get an oof in chat for Oracle?
Yeah, big oof.
You're a little spy.
Let me see your oofs, guys.
I can't teabag here, and I'm a little sad.
But, I mean, that would be pretty awkward.
Just wait till your father gets
home. Yes, there are oofs.
Furious about all this mess.
So this story is based a lot off of The Killing Joke, which is basically the origin of Joker and like what happened to Barbara, that she became paralyzed, and also Death in the Family, which is how Jason Todd dies. In the actual comic, when he paralyzes Oracle, he knocks out Gordon and then strips Oracle naked and takes pictures of her and then shows Gordon to like break him later on. It's really fucked up.
That is horrible.
Yeah, but that's like comic book Joker really messed up. Okay. I gotta do the spinny spins now. I forget what I gotta do.
Tom.
Yeah.
I was just looking for emotes on YouTube. I don't know why, but there's an emote for elbow coughing, but it just looks like it's a dab.
That's awesome. Tapping on the physically handicapped.
No.
Yes. To the main event.
You would have thought old Jim Gordon had been through enough. First, some handsome young maniac cripples his daughter. Now he's blaming himself for her being taken.
I think I'm gonna take off.
Yeah, go ahead, dude. I'll finish this up and then I'll end the stream. As long as I can figure out how to end the stream. Oh, I got it.
Yeah, you just click end stream. Or stop streaming.
Yeah, go do your thing, dude.
Yeah. All right, everyone. Have a good rest of the night.
I hope you have fun with your mom and your sis.
And I will. And have a good rest of the stream. And maybe you will watch Avatar tonight. I'll let you know.
Yeah. Live stream Avatar? Question mark.
Yeah, that's a guarantee for a copyright strike.
Alright, now that we got rid of the dead weight, it's just me and the chat.
Yeah, thanks. Alrighty.
Jim's on his way up. I can't do that now.
What do they want me to do? Oh, yeah. Oh, Jesus. Pick up wheelchair. I'm just gonna use the wheelchair for the rest of this game. Forget the Batmobile.
Oh god, no.
This is awesome, because now I can take these Apple earbuds out of my ears that have been killing me, and since I don't have to hear Noel anymore.
This isn't your fault, Jim.
Of course it is. Crane's done this to get to me. I should have been here.
There's something I need to show you.
He just starts undressing.
She's not like us.
Identity confirmed.
She's
Abigail, I do not want to love the Batmobile. It is not a mutual relationship.
Works for you? This is all your fault.
I will find her.
Gordon just legit.
She's my family.
She's all I got.
She's all I've got.
He definitely just broke at least a knuckle right there.
I never should have trusted you. Never. I'll do this on my own.
Yusef, you need to relax. I don't even think it has an exhaust pipe. I'm very shocked at how far ahead, how soon this is in the story.
I think that went quite well, considering. Of course, I wouldn't have told him, but that's why it's so...
Izzy, does it surprise you that the voice actor for Joker here also does the Fire Lord and Luke Skywalker? Alright, what do I gotta do here? You can't do that with a wheelchair.
I need to find out what happened to Barbara. They covered their tracks by disabling the clock tower security cameras. If I hack the municipal CCTV system, I should...
Yeah, Mark Hamill plays the Fire Lord.
To the building.
Isn't that crazy? I'm gonna take off my glasses. Ouch! Very shook. Now I gotta go through this video footage.
No, that won't work. I need to... That's the Arkham Knight. He's got Barbara. I need to confirm which car he took her in.
Is that the car he took her in? Yeah. So I should... That should work. There we go. Jeez. No,
really? That's the vehicle
really?
They took Barbara away in. Those tires are Amortech D60s. I can program the Batmobile to track their unique tread pattern. It'll lead me right to them.
All right. I'm gonna go up here.
Now that I think about it, how did Scarecrow know to go after your IT department? I mean, I had no idea she worked for you when I shot her.
That's
I just got lucky.
So stupid. Alright guys, I think I'm gonna end the stream here. We've been going on for a couple hours. I may continue to do Arkham Knight, I may not, but I know that Noel and I plan on doing more streaming since we have a lot of time. He talks too much. I know that we're gonna be doing a lot more streaming as time goes on with quarantine and everything, so feel free to check us out.
And thanks for you guys for commenting and stuff.
Alright, so I'll see y'all later. Peace.